Jealousy.
Synchronicity.
Sasquatch.
Homunculus.
Alien races.
Satanism in Hollywood.
MK Ultra.
Tartaria.
There's like a whole... I've been watching this one guy that...
Close the door, in.
Jury! Close your door!
What's Hello, everyone. We're coming.
Disagreements.
Ghost Dad.
I like that movie.
Dogman.
Bohemian Grove.
Corey Feldman.
Magicians are demons.
Specters and
spirits.
Sleep
paralysis.
Strange disappearances.
Sky whale phenomena.
Yes.
Alternative history.
Shadow people.
Shh, quiet. I'm trying to say words with the mouth.
It's getting dicey out there.
Poltergeists.
That's cool.
Anunnaki.
What is the moon?
Jeremy, what are you doing?
Elf towers.
I would never talk about it. That's old.
Y2K.
Cover-ups.
Apocalyptic catastrophe.
Vampire.
Hello. Hello.
There he is.
Hello.
Hi. Okay, hi. Can everyone see us? This is the question.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's going. It's going. Oh, it's going again.
What's going on?
I don't know. Are you playing that again? Oh, you know what? You know what? Oh, you have your delay. Hold for technical problems.
Me?
Is that you? Is that coming from me? Oh, no. We're getting a delay of the signal.
Oh, my bad.
Signal.
Maybe.
John.
Apocalyptic catastrophe.
Is it good?
No, still... I don't know why it would be...
Oh, because there's the delay. Unless it's live. Someone's hearing it back. Oh, wait.
Hello.
Wait a second.
Hello.
How are we getting...
Hello. What's going on?
Okay, can...
Okay, there we go. There we go. Okay, I think I was... So I was in the YouTube studio.
Oh, weird.
And I was playing our... I was playing our video.
Oh, you were doing
I
that?
I guess it does that automatically.
Oh, you have your delay.
No, it's coming from my DAW.
Oh, it's you.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Weird.
I mean...
Well, hi, guys.
Hi, everybody.
Sorry.
Hi.
About our technical difficulties.
We're still working through the technical... Okay, that's weird, though. Yeah. I don't understand why it's coming out of my... Anyways.
It's done, right? It's a piece?
Yeah, but that means I can't play any audio from my computer.
Oh, darn. Weird. Okay. You had all those cool sound effects loaded up.
I had that
like fart
cool...
sounds, because
no,
that's cool.
I had a cool music that I was going to dance to.
You should have danced to the intro.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. That was good. That was like Mega Man dance music. I was excited about that.
I guess it does...
John?
That
we'll have to figure that out later.
Yeah. Okay.
Anyways,
poor form.
How's it going?
Oh, hey, high five. Look,
hey,
we're in the same room.
Yeah.
Hey, high five to all the Belieflings. Hey, Brian. Good to have you with us.
Hey, Brian.
So what do we got today, Jer?
Well, you're the taskmaster.
That's
you're the
true.
One with the notes.
That's true.
You tell us what's going on.
Well, you guys each sent me some videos to review and some interesting news articles to discuss. So this hopefully will be intriguing, uplifting, and terrifying, and... reflective.
We've got
show.
We've got shark attacks.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
mm-hmm.
Only one. We've got robots.
Got robots.
We got some lights in the sky. We even got a tornado.
Oh, you brought a tornado.
I did.
All right. Oh, we got to do a quick hello for just some of the people that are in the room. Just say hi real quick.
Yeah.
Just because we wanted to say
hi
for those that made it right away. We got like 23 people in here. So, you guys can't see this, can you?
No, that's why I was saying throw it up on the screen.
Throw it up on the biggie. I guess I can't right now.
On the big easy.
Hey, Aaron Harmon, BH. Hey, that's our name. Tammy Andrews, Adam Gustafson, thank
all right.
you for being here. Lindsay Maves.
What?
Lindsay Maves, she's the one driving in a truck full of people right now?
Yes.
That happened?
Lindsay, hello, truck full of
I
people.
I hope she's not watching the stream.
We're glad to, why wouldn't she be?
Because if she's driving the truck.
Oh, that's
I'm sure she's
really
not driving.
Really funny, Chris.
Lindsay. Astute comment.
Astute.
Anyways, we'll check in with you guys as we go. Beth Crutchley, some familiar faces here. So thank you, everybody, for being here for our, I guess this is technically our fourth live stream, right?
Correct.
Yeah, feels like a first.
Second one in...
Feels like a first. It does in a lot of ways right now.
Second one in the new studio, though.
Yes.
In the new studio space.
It's still being updated, too. We got a lot to do to this place.
We do.
Maybe some neon signs, maybe some knockoff alien masks that are really... Explain that, Chris. Oh, yeah. So we almost bought these. Oh, if you see this ad on Facebook, do not buy movie-ready alien masks for $39.50 because they are not legit. We almost bought four of them, but they turned out to be cheap nylon or cheap latex.
Silicone?
No, silicone's the good stuff. That's like where it'll move with you and mm-hmm. the mouth will go open and close.
The implant.
Yeah.
Man, I would have loved to have those things.
I know. That
would
have
been
great.
Fun.
Oh, we could have done our spoof alien dudes in those masks.
Oh.
I didn't even think about that.
Yeah, that wouldn't fit their voices, though.
Yeah,
they're more
right.
like reptilian.
Like giant reptilian guys.
Oh, I think it'd still
guys.
Be funny, though.
Yeah, it would be funny, but it wouldn't be accurate. Don't bother me.
God. Okay.
It's got to be right.
It's got to be right.
Or just right.
Do it right or don't do it at all. All right,
so what's first on the docket today, guys?
Do
what
it
are we
right or don't do it at all?
What are we looking at here? Oh, Chris is pulling up elephant videos. I'm sure that's not going to be our first item, is it?
No.
Oh, yeah. Elephants are usually in a paranormal podcast.
Well,
number one.
Today's going to be interesting because we have a lot of different sorts of videos. It's not just ghosts and aliens today. It's sky creatures. We're going to be showing some videos of some cool tech stuff coming out. And some... John, what did you bring? You brought tornadoes and sharks.
Tornadoes.
So we got nature, we got tech, we have then the typical ghosts and monster.
We got
videos.
The Boston Dynamics dancing robots, which
that's,
is horrifying. If you
yeah,
oh,
why,
yeah. Is
why
that
are
real?
You so afraid of that?
Because if they can, I mean,
if they can dance,
you weaponize that stuff. It's
dancing
like a straight out of
dancing
a nightmare.
And killing?
It's like straight out of a nightmare.
I mean, dancing doesn't seem very threatening.
Yeah, but when you see the way they move,
let's see. Why don't we check it out?
Let's start with that.
Let's see what they're.
Let's start with it.
What moves they got? Let me go to your. We got a lot of videos loaded up here. John, yours is. Da-da-da.
Should be Boston Dynamics.
Oh wait. It's called "Do You Love Me."
Yeah. Okay. Sorry.
Is that the song?
Thanks, John.
Yeah.
Are you ready for some robot dancing?
There's already enough competition when it comes to dancing.
Jerry, throw it up there.
I need a robot competition out there.
What are you talking about? You feel like competitive nature?
I guess I don't feel
dancing?
Competitive dancing because I feel like I kind of like I can clear the room out, you know?
Yeah, no one's as good as John.
John literally clears the room with just the arm movements.
All right, you want
to
see
much.
It?
Yeah,
let's check it out.
Let's get it, Chris.
Too funny.
How to switch off. All right.
Too funny.
Screen to program.
I can say that every time.
That's what you do.
Ox, John?
Oh.
Yeah, we're having
Stop it.
I did. We're having some noise on our...
not important.
...video feed, so we have to mute off and on.
Go ahead.
All right. You broke my heart
because I couldn't dance. Oh.
You
so
didn't
sad.
Even want me around.
It's like me and
I do like
grade.
The song. I think it's a roommate. I'm back to let you know I can really shake them
down. It's good. Do you love me? It looks like CGI.
Oh, are you sure it's not?
No, it's...
I don't know, John. The last one
know.
You thought was real wasn't real.
This is from Boston Dynamics.
Could it be a concept
that looks
piece?
Kind of CG if you look at the motion. That's not real.
The feet on the floor. I'm looking where it makes contact. I'm not sure. Is this real?
I mean, I've seen those jumps before.
Something about it looks uncanny, as in...
Well, let's look. Let's
yeah,
look at the video. Look at the description.
Okay. That's your job, John. You brought it. Let's see.
They put out these videos all the time. It's from Boston Dynamics. It has to
true.
Be legit.
Our whole crew got together to celebrate the start of what we hope will be a happy new year. Happy new year from all... Okay. It doesn't say anything details
yeah.
about this.
It could be like a fun promo for New Year's.
Yeah.
That's possible.
Which would be so
but
lame,
why
John.
Would they do that, though? Like, they have the robots. They're just going to make a fake one?
Well, why don't we look it up?
Why don't you go to Boston Dynamics and see what else is on their YouTube page?
Okay. The Uncanny Canyon, Emily McMinn says. Yes, the Uncanny Valley. That strange place. Right between...
John, I think you're hearing yours back again. Yeah. I mean, they have these sweet ones, these doggy guys that you always see. This is the...
Really enjoying your YouTube
I mean, this
search.
Would be the model, right?
Oh, Jeremy, hush. Hush up. Look at the running one. That looks terrifying.
Hi, I'm a lady this? Saying words. I hated it.
Okay, so Zayden said the shadow looks real on the bot, and Tammy says you'll see the reflection in the windows.
Real. You can add that stuff, though, too.
Yeah, that's true, but I mean, I feel like they would say this was like a fun gag.
That one looks fake, too, but it's real.
Maybe it's just so awesome.
Look,
black
is white, up is down, left is right these days. I don't know.
That's pretty
cool,
though.
What's fake and what's real?
That makes me want to go yogging.
Let's just call it real, can we?
Do it. Yeah.
I think part of the thing that made it seem fake, it looks the same type of CGI as, I mean, it's real.
This one looks more real. I don't know. Maybe it is.
Part of the reason that last one looked fake, I think, is because there was no actual live sound. It was just the music. All the real sound was taken out, and that may have contributed to the fakeness, you know.
Oh, because they added the sound in afterwards, after fact.
There was
fact
no added sound at all.
Oh, so you didn't
they
hear,
took
yeah,
out
you didn't
the
hear,
real
hold on.
Sound.
That's a good point. Here's a... Wait,
Chris, you mean a screen to program?
I think this is something else, though. Yeah, it's different.
Preview to program.
Never mind. Oh. Never mind. I'm going to go with it's real because I want to believe.
It is real.
Okay.
It's not fake.
How much should one of these puppies cost?
More than your life.
I think we
worth.
Should get one for the studio
And you can replace you, John.
Can you just sit behind me?
Yeah. Yeah, but they don't have
you can call him
the
Jimmy.
Movement. John has
call
the movement. They're not smooth enough to match John's arm squids.
That's true.
What
are
you going to call them? That's true. Well, that was fun. That was a fun way to start.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. All right, John, you seem very worried about the future of robotics.
It's not that I'm worried. When you put them in the hands of the military and they arm these and then they patrol and say, you're not 6 feet apart, whatever. They have those in the Philippines right now. They have robotic dogs that make sure people are 6 feet apart.
Oh, I've seen those. Oh, we talked about that on one of our things.
That's like horrifying Brave New World type stuff.
Yeah, yeah. I think at least at this point they're just saying
it's fine.
They're just reminding you, quote unquote. There's no attack dog.
Well, yet. Right now.
Yeah.
But do we know
the next step?
What happens when we all become like communists, Chinese communists?
I think we'll have bigger problems to worry about.
Well, I think robotic dogs could be at
still
the top
be a big
of
problem.
List.
Yeah, that'd be
if they're armed.
Armed robot
and then
dogs.
And drones that fly and they're just like, have you had your vaccine?
They ask politely. just a nice reminder.
Please
along.
Check
in
there
at the
There can
CVS.
Be no human emotion.
That's pretty good.
Thank you. There will be no human emotion.
Yeah, I saw recently it was like a drone. I think you showed me that, John. It was like a flying motorcycle drone.
Oh, the
cop motorcycle.
It was like a cop motorcycle.
Yeah,
yeah,
but it was
flying
a drone. Basically, it was like four blades, mm-hmm. and then it's like a bike, but in the sky. And there was a movie where that was a specific element of the administration. I can't remember. Was it Total
Demolition
Recall?
Man?
Might have been the new Total Recall. I don't remember what movie it was.
Someone's probably gonna know.
Yeah, I'm sure people are. Again, I can't see the comments, so Jeremy,
I can pop it up there.
It's all on
Would
Jeremy.
That be helpful, or will you guys? Will we all just be end up looking at the monitor?
Do you love me?
Reading the comments.
Good question.
I can really
That's
move.
That's what we should maybe ask our listeners or viewers now. If we should we save like comment reactions to at a certain point in the show, or just kind of do it like we're doing off the cuff?
Comment reactions,
or not reaction, but just like engaging
reading
with
comments?
The comments. You know, because I kind of like check it from time to time, but I don't know if we should save it for a certain portion.
No, I think you can just check it as we go.
Okay.
Why are you asking them that?
Because they're part of the show.
I know,
John.
But that's an internal decision.
We should have a memo released.
That's an internal decision.
That's a big dog decision.
Big dog, which means it's John's decision.
It's my decision.
All right.
Well, anything else to say about robots, John, before we move on to your strange
Have you seen
lights?
Brian in the chat?
You're in love with this guy.
Into this chat. No, I have not seen Brian in the chat. He actually left a message that he won't be joining.
That's not fun.
He said he was going to, and then he was offended by you in some way.
Brian, are you out there?
There's a whole lot of people. There's 28 people so far right now.
Brian's the
let's
only
just,
one that
let's
matters.
Just
kidding. Just kidding.
Who's this Brian guy, John?
He's my childhood friend.
Oh, that makes sense.
He had a sauna with me today. We saunaed together.
That is a beautiful.
It was great.
Beautiful.
Maybe that's why he's not in the chat.
Was it a...
no,
it's like it was
be.
Weird.
He should be.
Was it a nude sauna?
No.
It wasn't a nude sesh?
Why would it be nude?
I don't. Some people like to be completely
How dare you?
Okay.
I was in my shorts and he was nude, but I wasn't nude.
Jeremy, leave my blue goo alone.
Oh, you want to tell the viewers what the blue goo is?
Oh, this is the official Belieflings drink. If John's okay with that, this is called a blue
okay
fjord. It is gas station vodka or GSV for the cool kids. Powerade Zero, the blue color, which is probably a raspberry
blue flavor.
And then Monster. That's the, if you want like the ice version of the fjord.
Oh, it's like a health tonic.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's an up brand, a downer, and a good all around.
Gas station vodka, blue juice, Powerade Zero.
Yeah. I don't think you're supposed to mix caffeine and alcohol.
Yeah, you don't always put Monster in there.
I have a Good and Gather. I promoted it last time.
Yes, you did. it was great.
It's a Target brand, but it's very good.
It hits the target.
It's good. Anyways.
Right. Okay, right. Let's get
now
back.
That the weird drink sponsors have passed.
What's next? What's next on the docket?
This looks interesting, John. You sent me a video of strange lights in the sky, which is not an uncommon phenomena.
Right.
This one specifically.
Yeah, this one is it okay.
This is going to be boring?
No, this one's actually interesting.
I think you sent me a couple, John. This one's from
It has a twist.
WCPO9
sort of.
News?
Uh-huh.
Is that the one?
Is it like little
fumes?
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's check it out. Jerry, you ready?
Let's do it.
It's blasted on up on the monitor.
Dun 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 dun.
Preview to program.
Oh, weird.
Can you full screen that, Chris?
Yeah, sorry.
They look like little fire sperm.
Oh. What?
Fire sperm.
They look like drones on fire.
Oh, they kind of do. Yeah, you can see something pulling those. I mean, that's weird. Piloted flame for sure. Yeah, look, you see the like little tick head on the top of those balls of flame.
Oh, what do you guys think it is?
Yeah, what do you guys? Oh, as you were saying, so there's like you can see illuminated by the flame something right above the flame, almost like it's pulling it. Yeah, it reminds me like it's pulling a flame.
What do you guys think it is?
Are you asking the chat?
Anyone?
Asking us? I don't know.
I have another video that explains it.
Oh, okay, so it is something. I would say, I mean, I don't think drones, because drones.
I don't know for sure that's what it is, but I'm pretty sure that. I just thought it looked cool when I first saw it. I was like, I didn't know what it was.
Oh wait,
if I saw this in the sky, it would be freaky.
This could be on some sort of tower, and they could be spinning down it, maybe.
No.
So this is an alien, is what you're saying.
I don't think so.
Okay. No, I mean it's maybe fire spirits, perhaps. That was gonna be my next guess. Fire spirits, but
let me see if I can see what
they also don't look very organized or intellectual. Ooh, for exciting entities. Where's Tucker? Yeah, they don't look like they're kind of like feel. I don't know. I mean, I would say this is a man-made thing.
No, but this, if you go to what is it? What's the link?
The other video?
Yeah, it's like sparks looking.
Is this the same one? That's SpaceX.
No. Mm-mm-mm. It's
Oh, this lady? Strange lights in the sky. We're sky
jumpers.
Yeah,
that's it.
Oh, the sky jumpers with flame hands?
Check it out. Roll tape.
Me on our 7 News Facebook page all day. Comments, shares, posts, and videos asking about the weird lights in the sky last night. 7 News reporter Amanda Cost is live. And Amanda, you found the source.
Yeah, you're looking at glorified sparklers
struck
to hide
trained view
experts. It turns out the
source up there with
is
them
almost as entertaining as the speculation.
It's pretty cool, though.
On the 4th of July,
talk like
you
that.
I know, there's
speculation.
There's speculation.
Really. Like came out of the clouds or something.
Something.
In the clouds.
They're muddy in the waters. I don't like it.
Look, they're going their weird way.
Look at that. They're going their weird way.
Look, they're going their weird way, man.
So who?
Asking.
What is that?
So who did this? Did you say at the beginning?
Well, hold on.
She might say. Let her speak her words.
This is weirding me out.
Uploading videos of the weird lights in Denver, Thornton.
It's not fireworks.
Legalized weed, you don't want a weird
exactly. This is not the exact same.
No, that looks different than the flame.
Yeah, it's not the same. It's not.
But the same kind of setup.
Yeah, I have to imagine it's the same thing that's happening. Yeah.
Or is this an advanced, what do you call it? PSYOP. Maybe they're throwing out some misinformation to make you think the other one was sky jumpers when it was really, you know,
sky jumpers.
It's fire spirits. Probably fire spirits. More important question, would you guys go skydiving?
No.
What about David Billings? You think he would go?
He looks happy.
He does. Contented.
All right, you can stop.
Bring it back here. Baby to program. Serious question, though. I was thinking that the other day. Would you... Because, you know, we're taking this break, and I was thinking, coming back from the break to the main feed podcast episodes, it'd be cool if we did something over the break that was like...
Skydiving?
An adventure that we could talk about.
Really?
And tell our experience and our feelings about it. And then I was thinking...
Our feelings?
Skydiving came to my mind immediately, because it's just something that people do.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm not going
Three
skydiving.
Podcasters died last week.
Very
inexperienced
jumpers.
I'd have to be heavily sedated, I think, to go skydiving.
No, I wouldn't. I mean...
Like
we could go
it?
For like a hike.
By the time
somewhere.
We got all the kinks worked out of the live stream
so
of that, we would
righteous hike.
We'd forget to put our parachutes on because we'd be fiddling with the ox.
Let's start on something a little bit more realistic.
Yeah, I mean it's easy to sign up for.
In the winter, skydiving.
Yeah, we could be like one of those channels that they film themselves doing Ouija board sessions. You ever see those?
Yeah,
good luck getting John to do that.
Yeah, I'm not going to do
no.
that.
No. Imagine like
you get a stuffed John
imagine
doll?
Doing that. Imagine like, oh, I really want to get a lot of views on YouTube. I mean, it's an exciting idea, but it's also like, in my opinion, extremely dangerous. To like,
it's demon, demon.
It's demon.
It's demon.
It's demon. But I do have a video about that actually.
Oh, you had a Ouija. Oh, you did send a Ouija video.
This, if you guys want to play, we could jump to that.
Sure. Well, do you want to look at the comments? Did anybody?
Oh yeah.
Well, I guess we already kind of spoiled what it was. So.
Someone said it's definitely fire spirits. So stay
hey,
with that.
You're validated.
Sky jellies, Jacob Steele. Amen.
Nice.
Sky jellies.
Did we get that clip of the sky whale?
Oh, the submitted one from the listener.
Did you bring that?
I didn't bring it in.
Okay.
But we will be doing that. I guess it'll be done on the main. We're gonna do a main, like a main YouTube stream.
We have that. We also have one from Bailey.
sent one in. Mm-hmm. It's really, really interesting. And I want to do it. I want to enhance the video. Right. And I just didn't have time to do that yet.
Okay.
It takes also a lot of time. One from Farnsworth guy, and we have one from
Farnsworth guy.
The Englishman. Farnsworth There's an English gentleman who sent us a really interesting video of a ghost after he took. This is really cool, actually.
Really?
He took. I was going to use it for listener stories, but it would work so much better in a live stream because he has video. Uh-huh. But he brought home a bunch of World War II relics of soldiers, like a helmet and like a rifle of someone who died in World War II.
Oh, really?
And yes, John. And after this experience, he saw and he got video of it. This thing on a staircase that kind of like shadow person vanished. Oh. Weird things in his house.
Oh, happened. I remember that was actually really interesting.
Yeah. So we'll have to do that on a live stream.
Here's a thought though for anyone listening right now: if you run across any interesting, cool clips, doesn't even have to be paranormal, but anything you find that's like, well, that'd be good for the show, send it along, because we'll definitely play it on the show if it's interesting. It's harder than I thought to find really interesting clips.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot of not great stuff.
Yeah, there's a lot of.
Here's a good suggestion. BH says, midnight walk in old growth Ohio forest near Wolfman.
Ooh, is this a,
I like that. Any place named Wolfman. I don't know if that's the place or if it's near a Wolfman.
Is it a link?
No,
near Wolfman.
No, I don't know if he's suggesting what we did on an adventure.
Wolfman, Ohio.
But it reminds me of the Silver Creek Dogman, which is right up the road.
Right.
Chris and I experimented with the camera, shooting some video out there the other day. Actually came out pretty, it looks really good.
Mm-hmm.
The quality was great. We could go to Defiance.
Or
I think it's near Cleveland, but there's the Wolfman there.
Johnson's Trail.
Johnson's Woods.
Brian and his wife went there. I'm sorry, I'm talking like he's like, I'm just going to share this. I mean, they were just going to go like at night at one point, I think fairly recently.
Mm-hmm.
And, I think they freaked themselves out and didn't end up going.
Really?
I went and hiked there the other day. I can imagine. It's so remote.
I used to run there.
Where is this at?
It's in Marshallville.
This is the Johnson's Woods with the elevated trail. Went there with Zach.
Yeah. It's pretty remote. Yeah. It's
not fairly big.
It's like dairy farmland out there.
Right.
A lot of like rural. That's an old growth forest, and that's one of the
trees are
armpit
awesome.
Of trees right there, and then around it's like the last vestige of old forest. And really, there's no forest in the area except for right there. It feels
right.
Like, yeah, it's an interesting place. It feels almost magical in that.
Very magical.
Let's do it. Midnight romp.
Yeah, I don't know. The thing is, though, it's so isolated that I don't imagine there being much wildlife in the form of like a large.
No, it's exactly where they would go.
But it's so small. It's just a little piece patch of forest.
I know, but it's perfect for feeding.
Well, think about it, Jerry. Think about it. True. Silver Creek, right?
Uh-huh.
We talk about that, one of the first dogman sightings that was reported. Yeah. And that's the same thing. It's
no, but you got Silver Creek is, you know, hop, skip, and a jump to, we have Doylestown.
Yeah, but the valleys and the trees.
Yeah, but there's still.
We're kind of talking about inside baseball right now because no one knows what we're talking about.
I know, but but generally speaking, the forestry around. Where Silver Creek is in Wadsworth, Ohio, it's not too far from random patches of trees and forests that lead up to like Akron area metro parks.
Yeah.
Big open, you know,
fairly amount of large
space of trees. But yeah, I don't know. We should definitely do some kind of an adventure. I would suggest.
Absolutely.
I'm down for that.
Yeah, I don't want to fall into the trap of doing something, terrifying and dangerous for the sake of a good story, because I think people do that sometimes. I think you risk, you know.
Well, when your
soul,
it's not just like necessarily for attention. I think I remember when we did those videos for your class mm-hmm. back in college or just after college. I remember filmed one for like a lighting test, and I had to take off my shirt for some reason. And you pulled me through the snow.
Oh, John did the music for that.
And there were multiple takes of it.
Pudgy blue front.
And that was my hair. My hair was pudgy. But that was years earlier, John. You're mixing.
Continue your story.
You're mixing insults. But yeah, I remember the idea that like I was freezing. I remember thinking like after the fact, I took a hot shower and I thought I might have to go to the hospital because I'd been laying in the snow with my shirt on.
You know what?
In the moment it was so. I was like, if we can get the shot, it's so kind of dangerous that this shot would be kind of a special shot. You know what I mean? Like it's interesting because this guy
when the camera's on,
the reason
you're
why
willing to go to the
exactly.
extreme.
Yeah. Well, we were trying
to get that shot.
I was playing a dead guy
And the evidence of that is that I'm laying with my shirt off in the snow. No right. person living is going to be able to just lay there in
we
the snow.
We had a lot of takes because
right?
so he wasn't laying correctly.
You were a star.
Yeah, we'll put that in the show notes for you guys. A clip to that.
Yeah, I was going to say we'll just post it in the. It's on YouTube somewhere.
Yeah, but no, that feeling of when you're being filmed, and when you're working on a creative project, the idea of going.
Oh right,
to any
to get the right. Well, we know that to get the.
I mean, I think everyone feels that. That's why there's such a push, you know, in the social media world to do like whatever to get like
crazy stuff.
Yeah.
Well, that's I think. Well, I think a lot of people do it to get like, hey, how many views can I get?
Well, yeah, that's.
But we're talking about like to get.
It's still the same concept, though.
Well, one I think is more of like fame or you're doing targeted specific things to
right,
get as many.
The point is, you're willing to do extreme things to get it on camera so that you can show other people.
Right, yeah, but I mean, like, to make the project as good
as
it can be.
I'm just saying, it's a similar
thing. No! If we can get this shot, like you're in a helicopter
Let's
for a movie
or
something.
Let's get back to interesting
anyway,
things.
Anyway, Sean, you were really shaking the table. All the cameras are, like, fuzzing
Let's
out.
Get back look. To interesting things.
Look, John. Look.
I'm angry.
I'm angry.
That's a serious business.
Well, should we What's go to it? Let's go Ouija board.
Let's go Ouija board.
Let's go Ouija
board. I'm going to go.
Let's sidetrack. All right, yeah. John's going to be in and out. John said he'll be in and out tonight. He has another live stream he's going to be jumping into.
I got to jump on the other live stream.
All right, what are you pulling up, Chris? Is this going to be the Ouija thing?
Jerry, you sent me, you sent it to me, right? The Ouija board thing? Oh, I have it. Nope, that's me. That's mine. Jeremy, it must be in here. Chica-chica. What's it called? Oh, wait, was it a QuickTime file or was it on?
No. It was in the notes. It's from Mellowbird. This guy's done, it's kind of his thing. I think he lives in a haunted apartment or home.
Is this guy with the shadow person?
No. Oh, that one's awesome. I totally forgot about that one.
You know what? You sent me this one. It doesn't work. The application can't be opened, and it says -50.
No.
Yeah.
No. That's not it. The one from Mellowbird?
Yeah. At least the link, whatever, how you linked it. You linked it oddly.
Are you connected to the internet?
No, but I did that earlier with my internet on. Sure.
Right, but I'm saying, are you connected to the internet now?
Not now.
Well, we can skip this one. But it's
we'll come back to it. Yeah, I do want to do that. Ouija board videos are the best, in my opinion.
Yeah.
The best of all videos, John.
I'm back. You know, Chris, you can probably turn it on, turn your internet to load it, and then just turn it off again if we have issues. We were having some streaming issues earlier with the connection, so we were concerned. So we were shutting everything down, shut it all down, just to keep it safe.
All right, fingers crossed, everyone. I'm turning my Wi-Fi back on. Hopefully it doesn't crash the...
It'll be fine.
The grid.
And do I need to... I'll resend you that link.
Yeah, it's on, Jerry.
But yeah, this guy, Mellowbird, he lives in a haunted home of sorts, and he's got a bunch of crazy videos. And I think this is just the Ouija board one. But there are ones where he... like things catch on fire behind him.
Is he Welsh or something?
I have no idea.
Does he have an accent?
I don't remember.
Okay.
Maybe. I'll send this to you real quick.
Okay. Let's load this up.
Mellowbird.
I do have, John, if you do get a little frisky later with all of your good and, what are they called? Good and kinds?
Good and gather.
That's the Target brand.
Good and gather.
It is the generic Target brand. But they're good. Those are good. I would agree.
Good
and
gather.
Just happen to have in this bookshelf back here.
I'm not doing the Ouija
board. This was given to us actually by Nick after he had a bad breakup. And he thought this might have something to do with it. So maybe we shouldn't.
Maybe we shouldn't
play it.
I don't want demons attached to me. I know not everyone believes that, but I have enough demonic activity in my lifetime.
Well, it's like, why roll the dice, right? I mean, part of me really wants to play again because I've done it before, and we did have that one really intense experience at Abby's house, Jer.
Yeah.
Where legit stuff happened.
Legit totes.
I'd like to do it just because, like anything, it's fascinating. But it is definitely, you are kind of rolling the dice. I do feel like that is a concern.
It's like you're like in an ocean. You're just dumping some chum in the water.
Right, in the astral.
And then
you're
like, let's jump in and see what happens.
Yeah.
You might get a shark. All I'm saying.
Yeah.
But you might get a friendly jellyfish.
You think it's possible to get a good thing? Do you think that's possible?
It's all demonic.
Do you think everything is demonic? No, I'm seriously curious, though. Do you think that there's...
I think John's open-minded.
I feel like there's... I agree that there's a lot of entities out there that...
I don't think there's... No, I personally don't.
I think there are tricksters.
I don't think there's a such thing as good things floating around.
I guess my question is, could there be a time, like in limbo, between this and the next life, whether it's, if you want to say heaven or an afterlife or reincarnation, whatever you believe, is there a possible time where there's a, like a transition, like you may get stuck because of trauma temporarily? Like, do you think that there could be a membrane that exists, like a substrate of existence where you could get, you know, you're temporarily held or you haven't been able to move on, you're somewhat still connected?
It's not scientifically possible.
I think we're thinking two, three dimensionally. What about other entities that are like lower life forms or that are, that might exist in another dimension near to ours that aren't necessarily dead or alive, but just might be able to communicate? Like, I think to just assume that it's either demons or dead people, I think we're really like limiting the possibilities. Who knows what could communicate? You know, people have, it's, there's stories of people connecting, demons. Connecting. And, well, yes. Demons is always possible.
It's, yeah, I don't know. I just think it's all,
I mean, don't demons. Get me wrong. There's plenty of accounts of, you know, terrible things happening after using Ouija boards.
We did, I'm more worried like about like a leech getting stuck on you.
Yeah, me too. I mean, that's, and that's again, I think there is, it's reasonable to consider the idea that, what you might think of as a demon might be some other dimensional parasitic thing,
yes,
that just feeds off of your energy, whether it's good or bad energy, and just drains you. And yeah. I don't think it's necessarily not a biblical demon. I think that those are probably real too, but I think that there's a whole consortium of crazy things out there.
I'm actually wrong.
I'm gonna piggyback on that. There's a couple of good comments here in the chat about that. Jacob Steele said, in my experience studying the occult stuff, demons only have power over you if you are scared of them. And that's an interesting point, because we talk about, you know, don't
feeding the fear.
Yeah, starve your ghouls. Because yeah, there's something ghouls. To that.
I don't know if that's, I mean, I understand what he's saying, and I think that's true. But I think if you participate, like, just because you're not scared of them and you, like, you have a symbiotic relationship,
uh-huh.
I think that can be, you know, if you agree symbiotic. To.
Oh,
you know,
like a.
Yeah, yeah, if you're like, I want the power, you know.
Yeah, I, Aleister Crowley kind I'm of thing. Thinking more like, if you come in contact with, or there,
right.
there's some negative force.
I
like,
do. It depends
if you
on,
are
right.
weak in the sense that like they like the fear.
I think weak may be a better way to say, like, if you're not mentally and psychically strong
or
to some
spiritually,
degree, spiritually,
yeah. where you just feel like grounded. I think
right.
if you're not grounded, you're,
if you're all, scattered emotionally and psychically.
Right.
And
also I think when it comes
well,
to,
let me finish.
Oh, sorry. Continue.
Then I think you're definitely, there's a lot better chance that something could like host on you.
Yeah.
Yes. Host
I,
on you.
I think another thing to think about that is, also when you give that, it's always like the, like I will give up, you know, my soul or whatever for this certain power at this time in my mortal life. But there's never, you can't, I don't think there is a, if these situations do occur, there's not a retraction of that. There, you're never going to win in the end in these situations. And right. you hear a lot of stories, and there's so many accounts of this where people have entered into these ceremonies and things like that where they're, have had alleged powers given to them, but it never works out well.
No.
It's like any right. story from, you know.
Right. It's like you get a temporary, like, power surge, but yeah. in the end, you
and I do, hey. If it's not too dark, I'd like to do an episode this upcoming season on this exact thing, because I have a few stories of people who entered into these contracts and then.
Is that from Rosemary Ellen Guiley?
No, this is from, I can't remember the researcher's name, but it's a.
That would be interesting, though.
First-hand accounts, like he interviewed these people. One was a woman who eventually she, like she was a huge part, she ended up like, oh man, it gets really dark. It's like she entered into this thing. She was given like the ability to basically know where people were at all times, that she would think about somebody, she'd know where mm-hmm. they were. It's kind of, which seems cool, but one of the sacrifices was she had to give up her baby basically to.
Her baby?
Yeah, to be. Ceremonially destroyed.
It's about the show you're watching.
Ceremonially destroyed.
Well,
is that
to
the
use
nice
a euphemism, yeah.
In a ritual or something.
Yeah.
Oh man.
And but it was just one of these things. Like she
so
believed
disgusting.
It was, you know, in the long run, mostly beneficial for what she was trying to accomplish, which,
right.
which
be,
is crazy.
Satanist?
Which is, you're not looking at the macro scale.
Yeah, I think
know?
All
like,
the people that get involved in that, it's very short sighted.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
in the end.
To that point, Jennifer Dabrowski says, you open a gate for one, you open a gate for others.
Oh, I like that. Yeah.
That's definitely true. I mm-hmm. feel like that's one of those. I think the good points, too, is people are like, well, I've tried. I was contacting my grandma. Seemed like she came through, or I was reaching out to someone that I knew and loved and was hoping their essence is still around or something. But then you oftentimes get either entities or
the
things
use that
pretending to be
trick their
right.
way into your soul.
I think what she's saying is that we should. Begin a game.
Oh, good Lord.
Right? No?
Nope. All right.
Don't be.
Someday.
John's just like.
No, I don't care. I will.
No, I don't think any of us are actually going to want to do that. Because I am. I've read too many stories now.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not afraid, you know?
Mm-hmm. Maybe after a few more Miller Lights.
I'm not afraid of anything. You know, man, it's not like I'm afraid. What accent is this? What are you doing? What is happening, John? It's not like.
Oh,
I'm
did you
afraid.
Send me the Ouija board video, Jer? We can jump on. And
I sent
that.
It to you.
Oh, you did. How did you text?
Womp it up. It's in the
womp,
chat.
Womp it up.
Womp it up. All right, again. Loading it here.
You're so cool.
Womp it up. Oh, womp. Wow, John, I haven't heard the fuzz. That's good.
That's because it's
been
on
while
mute.
While you're loading that.
I just hit play, I heard it. Hmm? I just hit play and I heard it.
Oh, did you just unmute it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Womp it up.
Sorry, it's commercial music.
Womp.
It's ready. Oh, this guy. Yeah, I think he has an accent.
Oh, you want me to put it on?
Yeah, let's go. Any background here? Well, I guess you kind of gave some background. The title of this video is called Ouija Board Gone Wrong at Halloween. Full version. Scary porn normal.
Scary porn normal?
Question mark? It's a whole new category.
Paranormal activity.
I'll link this guy in the notes for this show.
Paranormal.
I've seen this guy before. I like him. He seems legit. But you never really know.
Totes legit.
I just get a vibe from him that he's legit, but so much happens there.
Right. Okay.
In his domicile.
Should I preview the program?
Preview the program.
Preview the program.
Here we go. Get ready.
Preview the program.
Get ready, Belieflings. Here it comes.
Hey guys.
Oh, I remember this one.
Happy Halloween. We're going to try this again. Didn't work out too well last time. I'm a bit like this, though. If you didn't see what happened last time, I'll take to fire. Up there somewhere. 1, 2, 3.
Jeez. That's pretty startling. Yeah, so this guy...
I didn't swear.
Are there videos of faked glass breaks like this is like a thing?
Yes, this is something that can be done.
I'm still hearing his reaction.
I'm tempted to run out the garden. I really can't do anything with that anyway. Okay, what noise is going on?
Does he do anything else?
Yeah, wait for it.
Oh, shit.
All right.
It's getting real.
That's pretty much garden time. The power of Christ compels you.
Next to the knives, bro.
I feel like a fool. Let me go.
Dude, that'd be terrifying if that was real.
It's got some balls and it's real.
I'm using my Ouija board.
You really gotta fix the sink thing.
The power of Christ compels you. That's terrible. Garden time.
Jeez. Crazy.
Must be pretty used to this if he can joke around.
Yeah,
like that.
Well, that's the thing.
If it's not
his house,
fabricated. The reason he started a channel is because his house was. I think that's why.
It might be.
I'm sorry. He goes outside and then he watches from the outside. Things continue to occur.
Oh, that's me. That's me knocking.
Why are you knocking at the ghost? Hey, over here. Perform for me, gorilla. Asking for trouble.
This must have gone viral. Pretty compelling.
Yeah.
Where does it... Does it do more? Hello, ghost.
I don't remember this part of the video. I think I've seen clips and I don't think it's included this part.
It'd
be funny if his friends come in at the end, like,
hi.
Yeah, like,
oh,
how do you see
that? Weird,
yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it'd
be
hard
string.
To fake that.
If it is fake, they did a really good job because there's a lot going on in there.
Yeah. Well, and that's the thing. Like, you know, he's kind of like laughing a little, like... like scared laugh.
That's
a little
like
bit.
A scared laugh, right. Not like it's funny. It's more just like nervous kind of laughter.
Yeah, like laughing to yourself to make you not so scared kind of idea. He, I mean, like I said, he's done so many videos now, because he's living in this place and he's supposedly staying there to, you know, track the goings ons there and the paranormal. So when it's like most people be like, as soon as that happened, I'd fucking run. Mm. But if you've lived there and that's what you do. You, like, I've seen other people.
Right. If it wasn't his first rodeo.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's interesting.
Yeah, it's definitely a good one, especially how the glass breaks at the beginning.
Yeah. I love, and then startling. When it happens, you just like you're frozen for right. a little minute.
He didn't even touch it, right? It was like
no, I don't even think he touched it.
He was about to touch, and it was just like shattered.
Yeah,
that would be. I wonder how you could do that.
There
if
are
you, if you could fake
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you know there are videos of specifically like because that's a form.
That was a very destructive break too. Yeah. It was like a explosion.
Yeah. Well, there that is a form of talking board manipulation where you instead of using a planchette you use a glass
of some sort. Yeah.
But there are a lot of videos of and I forget how it's done. We could probably try to find one, but where you can specifically fake that the explosion of a glass, but
mm-hmm.
I don't think it looks quite like that.
What else is weird too is if he was gonna fake that. I mean, there's a real potential like a shard could go in your eye.
Oh yeah,
like
yeah, you're
that
risking
close.
It. You're risking it.
But we say earlier you'll do anything for that.
That's
shot,
true.
You know,
people they have the false sense of security when the camera gets turned on. Sometimes.
Yeah, it's true. Oh, thank you, Patrick Brooks says solid video quality, fellas.
Oh, thanks, Patches.
Oh, Pat.
Oh, Patches, good friend in the
Patrick,
chat.
We might have him on eventually. Hopefully, he's doing his thesis for his PhD on conspiracy theory. So, well, it'll be fun.
Well, that may or may not be right. He can correct that in the chat.
That's what he said last night.
Oh, that's definitely what he's been pursuing.
Well, no, he said, he told me last night he's decided.
Oh.
That's going to be his thesis.
Well, I think that's important.
Yeah, because he feels like now especially is a time when people need to have someone to discern the difference between people who are extreme way out there, believe in the craziest without any background, without any evidence to support ideas that are just basically fiction told to them, as opposed to people who like look into things and there's legitimate breadcrumbs.
Turds in the punch bowl. That's what you're saying.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it's an important time to, I think the key for me is to be able to have conversations, to talk about things that are, unspeakable.
Oh, John.
Is that a real fart? What a great moment that you did that. In. Wow. Okay.
It worked.
It did. That was
that a sound effect or was that your mouth?
No, it's a sound effect.
Oh.
Oh, wait. What was your mouth? Oh, that's pretty
Please
good.
Stop.
No, it's not my mouth.
I was going to say, how do you get it exactly the same each time?
How He's old a... are we?
We're turning into one of those podcasts. Oh, no. This is like one of those morning show podcasts.
I wish you could see you when you do those. Okay.
Okay. Let's move along, huh? How about
let's
that?
Let's do that.
Hold on.
Hi.
It's not even going to you, John. John, no one can see you.
There we go.
There's a lot of dancing going on.
Missed it last time. Maybe we should take, you know, we adjust your...
Oh, you know, here, John. I'm sorry.
What?
Go ahead. Please.
What is happening?
All right, that's enough.
Everybody drink.
You know, we'll have to ask our patrons because on the last feed, your microphone was picking up a lot of stuff, so it would go to you a lot, which I kind of miss because your reactions to conversation were pretty golden and a lot of your dancing. So we might have to put it back to that. We'll see what people think.
Maybe.
Maybe indeed. Oh boy,
please.
Okay, let's find.
All right, this is the last one.
You really had a fart sound effect loaded.
I was. It's so dumb. I know it's the dumbest thing you could ever do. But that's kind of why I did it.
So it's just so bad. That scared me. I seriously thought there were people like behind me.
All right,
I'm not used to the sound effects, man. It's weird.
I know it is a little weird.
All right, what's next on the docket? Let's do something real.
Next on the docket, John. You want to do one of yours, or we want to do?
Yeah, let's do.
Let's see what I got in the pan, the bullpen here.
I don't know. What do you guys got?
I thought this was kind of funny. Let's pull this up.
You're doing a funny or you're doing a freaky?
Well, it takes some explaining. Why is it loading now?
What about the baby injured by ghost caught on camera? Is that a good
one? We could do that.
Let's do this. This is a good, solid one here. We actually talked about this on an episode. I forget which one it was.
We played it at the beginning of the Nightmares in Babysitting and Kids Say the Darkest Things, but it was an audio episode, so we couldn't actually show anybody the video. So now we can show them the video.
Yeah, I think this is one of the most compelling.
Really
okay, this was the thing. I think we said in the show that I believe this couple. They just seem genuine to me. Sometimes you got to go on instinct, I guess.
They definitely come off that way. I think they're from Michigan. I think it's a Michigan couple.
You hear that?
No, I just realized that you have a bowl of bugles. Like, set aside for yourself. To you just, like, one? Pick from.
No.
Like a little treat chest over there.
I don't
there.
Eat during the show, John. That's very unprofessional.
Very unprofessional. So what are you saying about this?
Okay, so this, we talked about this in the, yeah, Nightmares and Babysitting and Kids Say the Darkest Things. And it is, I think, one of the, I don't know, most compelling recent videos from a couple that just, they don't seem like shysters to me.
Those are the best tricksters, though.
What, shysters or couples?
The ones that you don't think are shysters.
That's very true. They could be committed to it, you know.
Well, let's take a look.
Yeah, well, let's play it. It actually, read, and Chris, I sent you the article, so before you play the video.
Okay, well, we read this on the show. I guess we'll recap it here.
It's been a while.
A little recap.
And, oh, for our listeners out there, you're going to hear a expansion episode drop on the main feed, and we're going to drop this one, I think, the Adventures or the Nightmares of Babysitting. Kids
Things. So we're the break. We're almost done with the break. It's another couple weeks while we finish building the new members platform, which I'm really excited about.
Ghosts.
But in the meantime, we are feeding the main feed, the non-members, non-patrons, with an expansion episode to try to get more signups. And at the same time, we're going to be giving you guys an off the cuff along with these live streams. But there's an off the cuff that's previously unreleased like a year
ago.
Yeah.
So basically, what we're saying is we're going to drop one on the main feed that you've heard.
Right. Yeah, so
if
you see them pop up on the main feed in like within the week, don't get too excited for the main feed, but we're also dropping it off the cuff.
Yeah.
So.
All right. So a Michigan couple says an odd image caught on video in their baby's room is a ghost and that it injured their child. Heather Brow and Joshua Higgins of Highland Township went public with the video from their baby monitor. It shows a blurry, pale form moving past the crib, at which point.
Sorry, what is happening with that? Advertisement.
I don't know. Don't look at the advertisement.
It's very distracting.
At which point, 15-month-old Lily stands up as if to watch. Well, we'll see. Well, I guess I didn't really need to read that because I think it's all explained here.
It is. Just let's play the news clip. Okay, let's roll tape.
Let's roll tape. Here we go. John, get on my bugles.
Oh, those are your bugles.
I can't eat this right now. I got my fake. Well, we are you ready?
Do it.
Oh, John Ox.
At number four now, it is video of the unknown. What is it? Is it real? And what is it doing there? A family in Highland, Michigan believes their house is actually haunted and thinks something is harming their little girl. 7 Action News reporter Alan Campbell went to the home to see for himself.
It happened here in this room as 15-month-old Lily was inside her bed. Caught on camera, something walks in front of her crib, catching Lily's attention. Whatever it is, the family says it needs to go.
It's almost like she sees something that we don't.
It's an image Heather and Josh say is haunting their home.
It was chilling.
Oh, yeah, this is a good one.
It was literally a chill down your spine, like that what if factor. Like, is this what I just saw?
Caught on the couple's nanny cam video a few weeks ago, what appears to be something moving in front of the baby crib.
I freaked out. I stopped what I was doing and I ran upstairs and I grabbed my daughter.
Heather says this so-called ghost scratched her daughter Lily and attacked her too.
It scares us that it could do something else. I mean, there was even a morning that I woke up and I had felt like something was around my, like someone's hands were around my neck.
A team of paranormal investigators came in and tried answering
some of
the couple's
questions. Yeah, this is one of the more compelling ones I've seen in a while.
Josh's father, Jim,
says it may be
someone who lived in this house before.
The story that I was told was the gentleman that lived here originally.
Leather man. Let's listen.
Committed suicide, apparently, by jumping out this window.
Leather was a poor choice.
Which is, of course, one full story down.
The couple says they don't know why the so-called ghost is targeting
them.
How do you
die?
They say they don't
window.
Want any part of it.
It's not physically just going after her. It feels like it's going after myself, too.
I couldn't get an explanation.
Those people
it.
Are genuinely concerned.
Yeah. So it's...
That's it's, creepy, dude.
Yeah.
Creepy.
I mean, to me, that's like...
For now,
I almost want to
say they will stay inside this place with Lily until they're able to save up enough money and move out.
And move out. Yeah. Alan Campbell, Highland News.
Yikes.
Yeah, to me, that's. I mean, if I was going to say proof positive,
that's
it's not proof positive, but
close. Just
it's just the most convincing story. Yeah,
the circumstances. There's a baby involved. That video is very
compelling,
descriptive visually.
You could say that like occasionally there's digital. Like if it was
that wasn't that
no though. Well now what I'm saying is occasionally like
no.
Thanks John
no
occasionally there are times where you have a piece of tape, recorded tape, things recorded over other things where you get that apparition, previous projection from a previous recording, or some digital artifact like that that's just already implanted in that recording in some way. But the problem with that is, in this story, they're genuinely concerned.
That's tape, though. Yeah,
that's not digital.
No, but there are digital.
But they're like digital. That was not a digital artifact.
It's moving. I'm not saying
it's
an
like
artifact.
A wispy.
I'm talking about like if someone like you in security cameras, for instance, there are times where you will see an apparition of something walk by, and it turns out it was a guy walking by the camera, but the camera didn't have time to pick it up.
Oh, you know? I see what you're saying. Yeah.
And so it
didn't have time to pick it up.
There are problems with security cameras when the frame rate's so low and the resolution is bad.
I see what you're saying.
Where it can be basically a trace of someone that was there for, or even if it's recorded, and they are looping it back. I forget exactly how this works, but I've seen it done where you'll get something that happened 3 hours ago, but it's faded and it's blurry and it looks like an apparition. That can't happen. But the thing with this is, if you combine
there's no one in the room.
They're right, and you combine it with the fact that let's just assume that this is a new piece of a new nanny cam. It wasn't returned to the store, and let's assume that what she said about
all
the choking
other
around her neck,
like feelings,
the corroborative
getting,
experiences
right.
were, and she just seems so genuine.
I think can you put it back on my screen for a second? I've been reviewing this back and forth, and
sure.
This figure does not look human to me. It looks humanoid, but if you look at it, it almost looks like a bulbous tum-tum. Almost like an alien.
Can you close your more videos thing? It's kind of blocking.
Bulbous tum tum.
Look, you'll see what I mean.
What
watch right here.
Tum-tum?
Watch. Look at the tummy. Look at the tum tum. Ready? He's gonna walk
tum-tum.
Like this. He's gonna stroll. He just reminds me of like a dopey.
I think it's a she.
Tall alien. I mean, it could be a pregnant ghost here. Ready?
Watch for the bulbous tum tum.
Wait, why is this? Okay, hold on. I'm new to the internet. Look at that. Look at this rotund.
Oh, yeah, I see what you're saying.
It just looks like
a pregnant woman.
The way it walks through, it doesn't quite look human.
Maybe if it's a ghost, she died when she was pregnant.
I think it's an interdimensional being.
And she's hungry for the baby.
I think it's an interdimensional
being.
Maybe
she lost her baby or something.
Maybe.
Yeah,
but it also looks like it's not wearing clothes. To me, it looks like it could be some
sort
of
No, I see
walking.
A skirt. I see like a nighty almost.
Oh, really?
I think it looks like she's wearing a nighty.
Maybe. Either way, it is very strange.
And the baby rises
like,
right at that moment.
Yeah, that's creepy. Man, I would be out of there.
That baby's like, what
was
that?
If I was the father, I'd be like, we're leaving.
There's another.
Now.
There's a long view there. Ready?
You don't stay with a ghost.
Like, that is something.
That is something for sure.
Anyway,
that was a good one.
Yeah.
What is the commenter saying? Have they responded? Are they out there? Is anyone?
They responded. Hello? What happened?
Is anyone out there anymore?
Yeah. Patra says, pregnant ghost? Pregnant ghost? Yeah, maybe. That's totally possible, right? Well, I mean, not necessarily that she's pregnant with a ghost baby, but that maybe she passed when she was pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's but if the baby didn't, could you still have a... I don't know. That gets complex.
There's no rules, Chris.
Or it could be the stoned tape, right? It's just...
Yeah.
The movement of that.
Don't love that
experience.
Idea.
You know,
I mean, I think it holds up in some situations. I don't think the stone tape theory. I think most of our viewers know what that is. The stone
Josh
tape theory.
Josh Wolfhard said it's one of those aliens from Mac and Me.
That's exactly what it looks like.
Do you remember Mac and Me?
Yes, with the rotund belly.
Can you pull up a picture?
Okay, yes.
Mac and Me. Oh my,
that's what I was thinking of.
I remember that show because of our good friend Zach and Nick. Right? Then they used to. Their mom used to play Mac and Me all the time.
It was the knockoff of E.T. I think. It was like, you know, like Dante's Peak and Volcano. You know,
I was thinking about the guy.
Look at this guy.
Am I thinking of McGee and Me?
Where's his belly? The belly's the important feature here. John, get out of my bugles. Oh, what is that? You got a new snack every day.
He's always snacking.
I'm glad people can see this now. Why they're not showing me his full body. I need to see his belly. Mac and Me, full body. This is a very odd internet search. There he is. Look at this dude.
This is very chewy.
John, look. Oh, you're not even showing my screen, Jer.
Preview to program.
Preview to program. That's Mac and Me, alien.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I was thinking,
hey,
I think
up,
I was
guys?
Thinking of McGee and Me.
Look, see?
That is a very good point.
Didn't it look like that thing?
It does, yeah. Maybe it is.
It looks like that.
It's so weird. It's got attitude, man.
Look at that. Is that a dance routine by the Mac and Me crew?
That was an interesting movie. There is a, I remember that, what's the name of that show that does the, they'll do the watch along before the internet, really. Space
something, Space Theater 3000 or whatever that.
Oh yeah,
really funny show.
Mystery
Science Theater 3000, I think is what it's called. But they do one to this movie and it's pretty hilarious. I saw it a couple years ago. But yeah, Mac and
Me. Okay,
man.
I was thinking of McGee and Me. Do you remember that?
Oh yes, that's different.
That's what
there's
I was.
There's no aliens
of.
In McGee and Me.
What was that? It was like a.
I don't remember what it was. It was a great show though.
Anyway, all right. Well, what's next on the docket? What we got? What else we have here?
You want to do another video?
Why not?
All right, let's see. Let's do.
Rotund.
I don't know what that means, John.
Are we ready to get into tech, or we want to keep going on this ghost train?
What?
Well, give us some options here. Throw some at us, Chris.
Well, we have.
What's babes?
Babes. Oh, this one's fun. Okay, so this is an interesting. Okay, so I want to know what you guys think this is. Ready? What do you think about this ghost video? This is police officers in Malaysia.
Aww.
This is at 3 in the morning.
What?
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 They at this point they yell, "If you are human, stop."
Hey.
No, they don't.
Yeah.
Kalau kau manusia kau berhenti.
If you are human, stop.
Wouldn't you assume it's a human child right away?
You would think so.
3 in the morning, though? That's nuts.
Isn't that weird?
So, maybe she got out.
Yeah, I mean, that's what happened.
That's it?
Well, it's a group of... This is from
it would be creepy
coast to
sure.
coast. A group of friends in... friends. That was cops for some reason. A group of friends in Malaysia were convinced that they had encountered a ghost when they spotted a child riding a tricycle in the wee hours of the morning. But the spooky sight wound up having a less than supernatural explanation. The eerie incident...
Oh, so there's an explanation.
Reportedly occurred in the city of... Penampang last Wednesday at approximately 3 a.m. Well, that is the witching hour.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it is a little ridiculous that they'd be like, if you are human, stop.
I probably say that too.
As the men were driving through the community, one of the passengers in the car was left bewildered when they passed a youngster that was inexplicably out and about at the late hour.
Yeah, it's just bad parenting.
Yeah. Eventually, the stunned man convinced the driver to turn. I won't read this whole thing, but I just thought that was kind of.
It's, you know, I mean,
interesting,
funny.
Chris.
It'd be better if it ended up being unsolved, probably.
Like an actual mystery?
Yeah.
As opposed to
since
a
we know.
Sad example of parenting where your child might be hit in the middle of the night?
Yeah. I know. Well,
tricycling on her
own? I can see, especially since they were on a tricycle or that little, because like you could, I can see a child getting hit by a car or something.
Right. Well, I guess the kid, it was the... He just wanted to go riding in the middle, like escaped his parents' house.
Right.
Yeah.
And
so
what a
crazy.
Brave little boy or gal. I'm not sure what it was.
Not a whole lot of common sense.
But. Brave little toaster.
No.
Well, I mean, it's thought provoking in the sense that, like, I do, you know, we hear about like black eyed kids stories all the time. You know,
yeah.
Kids when they're, you know, on their own approaching cars, just out,
mm-hmm.
especially late at night. The kids are just creepy. I feel like
in general,
kids
are just creepy.
Kids are creepy, and they can be creepy because they don't operate on
our
terms.
They don't have a filter. Like
they don't have
like,
a filter, and they don't operate on our terms. They, I don't know. There's something about the idea of running into a kid. And parents out there are probably like, "Well, it's just, you know, kids aren't that creepy," but kids are creepy to me, especially like yeah. But out in the middle of the night, even if it was just a person, if it was a lady in a wheelchair or a woman walking down the street at 3 a.m. you know, on her own in the dark.
Right.
That's enough to be freaked out.
Wait, what kind of lady?
I just said lady.
A wheelchair lady.
There's a lot
lady.
Of ladies.
Well, not like a walk around at 3 a.m.
A wheelchaired lady?
Prostitutes, perhaps. Yeah.
What?
Would be less
ladies
freaky.
Of the night?
Ladies of the night.
That's how they get their name.
Yeah.
Let's do another something in the sky video. John, you sent me one here.
What was the other one?
This is the...
You should do the SpaceX one.
Okay. That's what I'm on. That's what I'm on.
Okay.
So this is SpaceX.
This has an explanation, but it just looks insane. Like, can you imagine just looking up and seeing this? And it may not even be SpaceX. It could be a lie.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Maybe.
So
it looks like they're opening up a portal to another dimension.
It's supposed to be a reused SpaceX rocket carried 10 satellites into orbit from California
Friday.
Oh, Jeremy.
We got some satellites.
See, Jeremy,
for
satellites
you.
Are real. Leaving behind a spectacular trail. As it soared into space, it lifted. Okay, so it's just a rocket.
That's aerial. They build them on the ground.
This is just a rocket taking off. Is that this video? Let's check it out.
Check it out.
Previewed program, Jer.
Show. I'm your host, Stephen Colbert.
Previewed program.
This is a Colbert video?
You know it's live?
That's not my computer.
John, is that you?
If it wasn't live, they would edit out all this dead space I'm giving you right now.
What
is
happening?
Is Colbert invading
but
our...
What is happening?
John, this is your computer.
That's got to be coming from yours. Yeah.
Is there a commercial?
There's got to be something else open up.
Lord,
it's coming from your connection, son.
It is?
Yes, son.
Oh, boy. This is the problem with so many tabs. Steven, where are you playing?
Steven.
As I am tonight.
Steven.
I don't think this is my computer.
Steven Graham. It has to be.
Are you seeing my level?
Mm-hmm.
Really? Well, maybe if we just ignore it, it'll go
away.
Have
you had enough?
Stop it, Steve. Yes, I have.
After 5 years.
Oh, you're right. It is my computer.
Good Lord.
I don't know what that's coming from.
It's got to be coming from one of your tabs.
Lordy. I only have 40 open. This is hilarious, man.
What?
Preview program. I'm just going to watch you search. Search through all your tabs.
Okay.
It's going to be a commercial.
It should have a little, like, you know, speaker.
It's gone now.
Well, I muted my computer.
Uh-huh.
It's going to be... Sorry, everybody.
Like 50.
Sorry, everybody. Oh, they're just dropping like flies on the live chat right now.
Dead air.
Is he still... No, he's still there, Steven.
Just close everything.
Just close it out. Okay. Do you get it? I got a feeling it's the CIA page.
I really do hope you're enjoying those tax cuts.
It's probably a news article.
And those judges, because those judges are...
Mute that baloney. I don't know, man. Where he's coming from. I don't see any speaker icon up next to the tab. Usually that's how you can tell where...
Are you sure it's not like a message? Text message sort of thing?
No one sent me Steve.
Do you need the tech guy to come in? I can go over there and...
Oh, Steve did text me earlier today. I guess he's probably just playing his message here.
Was it about his ice cream flavor?
Is your computer still muted?
Yeah. I mean, it's really going to take a while to find all
this
these.
Is hard because we can't edit this out. People are just
they're just hearing it right now.
They're just like, okay.
We're so used to being able to edit our show and like make it the best it can be. The problem here is that my computer is the one that all the clips are loaded on, mm-hmm. and it's run to play these clips. So if I can't, I guess I can find it.
I'm the one that should be going.
Fine. There he is. Hey, Mr. Republican.
Mr. Republican.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? It was the strange lights in the sky. It just kept playing. Oh, guys.
Come on, Chris.
I'm so sorry.
All right.
Let's get back to it here.
Preview the program.
All right. Social media video captures SpaceX streaking across the California skies. Here we go.
Now, second stage light, right?
That's pretty sweet.
That's not...
Oh,
you know why it's so good? It's because sunset. It's getting the sun up.
Wait, that's not the one. I think it gets a lot better.
That's weird that it's, like, separated. No, it's just like a contrail.
No, it gets crazier.
Whoa. Oh, yeah. What? It's a rocket. It's giving birth.
Dude, doesn't it look like it's going to another dimension or something?
Look at inside. Look inside it there. You know, this looks exactly like... Freeman talked about this years ago. That's pretty sweet.
That looks cool. It looks like a sky whale.
You know, rockets seem... I guess they make weird...
Yeah.
It's a rocket. Things in the sky. Like, there was that Norway one, which I think is still kind of debatable.
That's
the spiral.
Oh,
the Norway
right,
spiral.
Yeah.
No, dude. What is that?
I can see seeing that, though, and being like, it's an alien invasion.
Is it,
right.
Is it because it's like it's city light pollution?
It's an aerosol dump. That's what it is. From a space vehicle.
North Korea. Come on. There's going to be
Oh, it's pretty sweet,
God.
Though.
Funny, cause I saw, like,
yeah, I found a look. How excited you'd be if you saw that? You're like, here it
I don't
comes.
Know if I'd be excited. I'd be kind of.
I would think
like,
it's a giant space creature giving birth to its young.
Yeah, that's where I would go first.
Yeah, I've got a whole, if you're interested, I have a whole collection of these that I just found.
Let's head on out here. Head on out of here.
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, you're out. Okay.
Chris, you don't have to tell me how to do my video switching job.
Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, John, that was, I mean, it was cool, but it definitely.
Yeah, it's nothing like.
Bop, bop.
Can we get your fail sound?
It has a little bop, bop.
I think we should probably go back to my screen real quick, here, because I think this is the most unexplained, incredible thing I've ever seen.
Preview program.
Skinwalker scream? Is this the Skinwalker scream?
Aww.
It's just damn adorable.
That is really adorable, Chris.
Thank you for this moment.
Sometimes you just need to take a baby elephant break.
Stuck on its tummy.
That's awesome.
It's adorable.
He's so limber.
They're limber animals, man.
His back is going to do it again?
Come on, buddy.
He just looks like he's smiling, doesn't he?
Adorable.
Look at that.
Smart creatures.
And you think animals don't have souls.
Get out of here.
I do know they can. I saw that documentary, Dumbo. All right, that's enough. We can break away here.
What about the Skinwalker scream?
Oh, you can go that. I don't want to. It's a hard left turn from the baby elephant.
Yeah. Sometimes you got to make them.
All right, Skinwalker Scream. Let's see if I can pull that guy up with no more Colbert interruptions here. Stranger with Candy. Check it out. It's a good show.
That was a good show.
Mm-hmm.
Kids in the Hall.
Kids in the Hall was an excellent show.
Well, I was thinking because Colbert's on Stranger with Candy. That's why I popped in my the old noggin.
Noggin? Who says noggin?
I just did.
Chris does.
John, did you send this to me or Jeremy?
I did.
Skinwalker Scream?
Yeah. I don't know if we... Okay, go ahead. I guess this could be an example of things.
Don't start a video introduction with that.
Okay, this could be... Well, no, it's a paranormal video. Apparently, it's really popular. It's got like, I don't know, 3.5 million views. And I actually saw it first on Nuke's Top 5. Really good.
Oh, yeah.
Paranormal.
Guys, I got a better one.
Well,
remember that?
John,
okay,
in
fine.
The middle
no,
of
no,
talking.
That's okay. It's okay. Sorry. I just got excited.
So, Nuke's Top 5, great channel. You guys check it out on YouTube. But he's one of the top, like, top five creepy videos channel. What I love about his stuff is he always posts where he gets them from or he tells you in the video.
Yeah.
Where they come from. A lot of people just regurgitate stuff.
There's so much out there. And I get the plight of people who do just creepy video stuff and release like every day because eventually you just get to the crap.
Right.
Because you're out of the legit
and
stuff.
And to me, well, we'll see what you guys think about this video. I think he got asked about this video by a large amount of people, at least like, I don't know, 10 people in his audience all asked for the same video. So he decided to end up doing it. And I have a feeling that he held back because he didn't believe it, maybe.
Okay. So you think this one's probably
I think it's bogus, but you guys tell us what you think. There's something that gives it away at the end to me. See if we can figure that out. John, you should know because it's an audio thing.
Okay.
Are you ready? Preview to program.
All right. Preview to program.
I'm up at the ridge line right now about where the fence is at. And so behind this fence over here, there's a wood line.
So this comes from, what is it?
948.
Mr. Dill, Big Dill. That's the channel.
I'll look after.
So we just heard a scream a little bit ago. I don't know if you can see past this, but so behind this, where I'm pointing right now, there's a forest back there, and that's a pretty big forest. It's a state park. So there's nothing that's back there, and it's protected. So I don't know, but we're back here, and there's this fence right here that protects my friend's yard, where we're at now, and from that, I don't know what you'd call this, but there's a pasture out here with a bunch of trees.
It's weird they're setting it up.
I don't know if you can see that tree.
Well, because they heard it earlier.
Oh.
So he's trying to film
that tree right there. That,
supposedly.
That fern, right? Right there, that's a fern, and then there's a bunch of other ferns all around. And then it gets more dense as you go back. But what happens is this creature comes up against this fence, and it jumps this fence. And it was standing, we think, right in this where I'm standing right now. And my friend's inside right now. But I'm getting this footage.
It's supposed to have just happened this night?
Did you just fucking hear
Whoa,
that?
Whoa, dude, if that's real.
That was fucking it.
Listen.
No.
See, Ryan played through a speaker.
That's reverb.
Go back to the very end of that, Chris.
The first part sounded
it's a maniacal laugh and like slowed down.
Yeah. And the reverb, you can tell by the reverb. Yeah.
The world's most advanced website design platform.
So what is happening, sir?
Made for.
I can't.
Just go back to the very end.
YouTube brand.
Go back to the very end of that.
Okay.
Maybe this is a different one.
Hit cancel.
Why'd it go?
Hit cancel. It's going to preview the next one.
No.
It's still the same one. Hit cancel. Hit cancel.
So I'm up at the ridge line right now, where the fence is at.
Okay.
Go to the end. Back to the lame sound effect.
Yeah. This gave it away for me. Like, the scream was cool.
So that's supposed to be a laugh?
That's what I thought.
Right in this where I'm standing right now.
Listen, guys. Listen close.
But I'm getting this footage. And did you just fucking hear that? That was fucking it.
So dumb.
Yeah, that second part.
That guy
really
needs
good.
To.
Shh.
Fuck this, I'm out. Fuck this.
Yeah, so real.
Aw, man.
Remember that rake that was caught in the woods that
I tried to. Oh,
I can't
yeah.
find it.
I have one rake here.
I
that's like behind the trees and like hanging off the trees and screaming at the top of its.
Oh,
lungs.
That was
that
actually probably the best evidence for a rake type
yeah.
creature that I've ever seen.
Again,
I
don't like that name.
That was in who's the channel that you were watching?
Whatever you, John.
He did a compilation of.
Oh yeah. Let's see if I can find
best
it.
Scary videos of the year or something like that.
That's right.
But if you can't find that this time, we can cover it next time. That was, one of the best pieces of evidence.
I'm going to find it.
In the meantime, we could do the evil creature one you sent me, Jer, if you want. Hey, well, let's look at the feed. What are people saying about?
Oh, people are just, they're in their own world now. They're no longer interested in anything we're doing.
That's good. who we got on there? Read some names. Let's give some shout outs.
Tammy Andrews, Natalie Rich, Emily McMinn,
Right. All right. Always here. Yes. Patrick Phillips, Sunny L. Oh, that's a new name. Jennifer Dabrowski, Aaron Harmon. And that's where I've, oh, and the 22G. Yeah. Nice. So some familiar names from last time for sure. And yeah, snorting. Oh,
snorting.
Patrick Phillips says snorting question mark. Oh, I wonder if she's referring to that.
Oh,
the
yeah.
The sound we
yeah.
thought was a laugh. Maybe not. I'm not sure.
Is that all the people that are in the chat?
No. There's 32 people. It's just hard to... It doesn't give you a list of names. It just shows you, like, the comment feed.
I bet it does, but you just don't know how to do
maybe
it.
Maybe, Chris.
I'm going to find this rake. Oh, there it is. Awesome.
You want to shoot it to me, John?
Yeah, I'll send it to you.
Hopefully it doesn't crash the mainframe. Oh, what's going on here? Oh, there it is. Why is YouTube Studio opening? What is happening?
I don't know.
All right, did you get it? That's a lot of whispered.
This is freaky, dude.
Whispered talk.
This is freaky, dude.
You saying over, bro?
I have to get it to the right spot, bro.
All right. In the meantime, Chris, will you play a clip?
Yeah.
No, we're almost here.
Okay. Are you got it?
People have a little bit of patience.
I guess yeah, they're talking to each other anyway.
This is in Poland. This is a farmer in Poland on his land.
Yeah, this one's pretty.
This is pretty compelling.
Pretty unique.
And the reason it's compelling for me is because of the audio.
Uh-huh.
It's
oh right, yeah.
Ear piercing sound.
It doesn't sound like it's from a speaker, right?
No, I mean it's not impossible that they could have a speaker back there, but it would have to be really loud.
Yeah,
and it just seems like if it's faked, it's one of the better. Everything
I feel like
about
the way, if I remember correctly, the way it moved seemed very hard to fake.
Yeah, the whole thing just seems pretty authentic.
Well, let's check it out.
Let's check
John.
It out. All right, I'm gonna
shoot it on over at me. Pew. Jenny, your laser sounds. After that, if we're up for it, we could do one that's similar. The one with the thing in the guy's backyard that he films from the window you sent me. Remember that, Jer?
He filmed from the window.
Oh, is that?
Oh, the screen door.
Yeah, oh, yeah. He's talking to someone?
On the phone.
Mm-hmm. That one could be fake, but it's pretty awesome. It's still creepy as shit.
I have that, and I have a little background, at least about the guy a little bit. I looked at his YouTube channel.
Yeah, John, yeah, laser it.
I still like.
did you send it, John? Or are you just making sound effects?
I sent it.
Oh, I did. All right.
You get it?
Oh, I received that into my soul.
Reproductive.
All right, so this is it, John?
Yeah, there's going to be someone else talking, but this is the beginning of the video.
Oh, we used this guy's channel last time. Yeah. He's.
Scariest movie ever.
Oh, yeah. Oh, great channel.
All right.
Here we go.
Organs or anything, and they
what? Oh, come on, we're gonna have to invest in YouTube Red for the next live stream.
Funnels.
Thanks. Let's watch this
thing
whole video.
No.
Camera, and it's similar to this creature called the Rake. That's a creepy pasta. That's
terrible
something
name.
That was created online, like a scary creature created online. Anyway, since then there've been some of these sightings of things. Like, actually, I have to look that up. I'm not sure which one came first.
Can I just skip to the?
Yeah, you can
get something.
Just you can use the arrow keys. You don't have to move that. It'll go over by like 5 seconds instead of trying to
add to that later. It's another one of my bookmarks here we'll get to in a bit. But anyway, so there've been some keeping all that in mind.
Oh, I guess that's right.
This guy does a zoom.
This is
in
the
too.
End. We missed the whole build up.
I didn't skip it that far. No, I don't think
what
you sent
up
me
the side of the wall.
Just
It looked like a frog, just moving fluidly, but it was much bigger. It was far away. It was more human.
Listen to the sound. The clicking.
Oh, I see it back there. Is it back in the woods, right?
Just guttural. Leave it, let it play.
I think they do a close-up in a little bit.
So meta. We're like doing a video of a guy doing a video on the guy's video. Jeez. How do you get that volume?
Dude, that sounds horrible.
It sounds like it's in that space, too. It doesn't sound like it's being projected. I wouldn't be approaching that.
Ew. Look at that thing, dude. It's disfigured.
It's got to be
one of the better, like,
either
they slow it down.
And then zoom in, right?
Yeah.
If it's a fake, it's one of the better fakes.
Yeah.
I mean... It's can you pause it for a quick second? They also do the, if it is a fake, they do the good job of giving you just enough to where they wouldn't, you know, play their hand of like,
well, let's not say it's fake. Let's say it's real.
Well, my thought,
go back.
Hold on. I want to talk about it for a second.
I want to see the close up before we talk about it.
I'll find the close up as you guys are talking. Go ahead, Jared. We're going to get into it. I just want to pause for a second.
I got it ready. Go ahead.
When I first saw this, I thought, yeah, you see the distance could be a guy in a skin tight white suit, just weird, doing weird things. You could have a speaker out in the woods. Like, that was my initial thought. But yeah, as we're going to show in the close up, I think it's more compelling after you see the close up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, here's the close up.
Because the body really does not look human.
Right. You ready?
Here's the zoom.
Almost sounds like it's in pain.
Yeah, or threatening. Like, get the fuck out of here. Earmuffs. That just does not... Like, its arms are so skinny.
That's when you run.
Dude, that would be it. Brian, if you're still listening, that we used to think about stuff you'd see in the woods and it would grab onto the trees and run as fast as it could. Like, that's what it reminds me of.
Created online.
Pretty crazy. Yeah. Jacob Steele said it could be another fella. The noises sound like something a person could make. Which I don't think so. I think you can do that, you know, that kind of like, but the amplitude
is distorting.
It would have to be projected or something. To make that
and
loud.
Then the gurgling at the ends, it does not sound human to me. I mean, I'm not saying it's impossible, but
I think the gurgling could happen, but I just think at that volume out there,
right,
it'd have to be something, I don't know, bestial. What's happening, John? What's happening here?
Just leave Jeremy.
Is this gonna be the Jeremy show?
Eat some bugles.
Chris, where are you going?
See you later.
Come on, don't leave me alone. I need some bounce back here. I've never done a one-man show. It would just be Jeremy's crazy corner. And I'd be like, listen, guys.
How's the chat here?
Knights have worms. There are worm knights.
How's the people doing in there?
The people is doing good. Got some interesting comments in here. Whole conversation happening. Oh, John, play Rubber Johnny video. Says BH.
Oh, Brian. Oh, that's you.
Oh, that's BH. Oh, that makes sense. Initials. Hey, Brian. I didn't put that together. He's been here since early on. Mm-hmm. He's been here since early on. Awesome. Sarah Hamilton, Corey Vandewig, of course. I'm his favorite. Hmm? Said I'm Corey's favorite, so yeah. We're gonna do one man. Cause I'm gonna do one man show. are you just gonna stand up and eat bugles? We are live on stream, John.
I'm doing it so that I don't,
Can we do a little bugle dance?
I'm really hungry.
Okay, well, eat before you come.
Do you want one?
Sure, I'll take a bugle. What flavor is this, John?
Can you play it for me?
Is this a Good and Gather bugle?
Try to play it.
I'm not going to try to play a corn bugle. All right, no, I'm not going to eat this. All right. Well, it's my show now, guys.
Dance, monkey!
I will dance.
I'm almost ready, Jim.
Hey, we got Brian in the chat. We got another Brian. Brian King. All right, guys. This is getting very unprofessional here as I'm left alone. I'm reading comments. Do witch hands. These are all for John dances. Wait, witch hands? What is witch hands? I don't remember that. I do not recall. Witch hands.
Do you need a beer?
This is your moment, guys. I'm alone with you since my brothers have left me. So any questions you have in the comments.
Jeremy.
Yeah, I'll take one.
Jeremy, you should ask the people in the chat right now if anyone has a video to share.
Yeah, okay. Does anybody have a video to share? Well, Beth Crutchley asked me about nightworms. You know what? Do I have control over this? Nightworms. You know, we're worm knights, to be accurate. Nightworms. I know it's crazy, guys. I love that right now it's on auto switch and still John's microphone is picking up the spirit of John. Worm knights. Okay, so I know this sounds crazy, guys. And maybe we can dive into Jeremy's crazy corner for like 30 seconds here. They're interesting depictions from medieval times. Historical depictions, statues, paintings of I don't know, this weird, I don't want to
talking about worm nights again.
Yeah.
Is that where we're going?
So like there's one specifically that I'd like to bring up, and I want to do a show on this. I really do. But basically let me just throw the concept out there. The concept out there is that, knights, in the Middle Ages, at least some of them may have been occupied, instead of by a human body, by a parasitic worm of sorts.
Yes.
Some sort of maybe extraterrestrial, interdimensional creature, demon, if you will. But there's all this kind of interesting lore around knights. They could never take off. They would never take off their armor in front of people. They had to be watered. They would literally pour water through the mask of the knight to water their body down to keep them cool, supposedly.
I mean, that makes sense here, though.
But there was no drainage.
You're in a suit of armor.
Right, but also, you know.
Worms.
Worms. I mean, this goes into a whole thing. There's a lot of really interesting anecdotes and attributes to this that I'd
like to talk
about.
It is a fun topic.
There's that one statue. Let's just give them the one statue sure. image. I can find it.
I mean, there's statues and paintings. It is weird how, like, there's a lot of statues and paintings where you have a knight with a removed helmet, and it is a...
freaking worm.
A worm head.
I think worm head.
It's got to, you know, be some sort of symbolism, right? It can't be a worm person.
A worm head.
I guess it could be a worm person. Stranger things have happened.
I'll find that image.
Could play Rubber Johnny.
The Aphex Twin video?
Oh, it's so good.
It just reminds me of the rake creature.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly. I think we put a clip of Rubber Johnny on.
I think we should play this real quick, Jer. This is another important milestone in paranormal investigation. I'm surprised people got this on video. Can you go to my screen here, Jer?
Sure.
This is
period of program.
Ready?
A movie normally scheduled at this time will not be seen tonight, so we can bring you the pretty following captivating special programs.
Yes.
Yeah. All right.
Yes. Oh, are you playing this now?
Yes, get it.
Competing for the title of America's best aerobic athlete.
This actually happened.
Man, what a better time.
Can we go back to this? Just let it play for a minute.
Get it.
Oh my god. So happy. So great.
Can we perform this live for like a special Patreon?
So good. I can't believe this happened.
Just let it play. It's so good.
Here we go. Let's break it down.
Crystal Light.
Yes. Alan Thicke is here. We have Alan Thicke.
Alan Thicke.
With two-time Olympic medalist and international sportscaster.
I guess Alan Thicke was nominated. He was like an honorary aerobics champion or something. This is the weirdest thing I've ever seen in my entire life.
The aerobics championship.
It's like the Olympics of the aerobics, essentially. This is just so bonkers.
People were very into aerobics in the 80s.
I kind of want to get back into it.
I just love that music.
Oh, it's so great.
Grab it. They're so into it. Let's get to the break. There's a breakdown point where they challenge each
other.
All
right, let's see.
Really? They're introduced to each introduced okay. as pairs.
Oh, right, yeah.
That's probably the best part.
They're so outrageously happy about it. It's scary.
Wouldn't you be, though, if you were listening to this, you were dressed like that?
Oh, yeah.
How could you not be happy?
You just lose yourself in the music.
Yeah.
Terry Lilly.
It's like our Patreon call out. Superwoman.
Weirdest thing is they're all straight.
You don't know that.
I know.
Okay.
All
right, here come the couples.
This reminds you of when you're in a wedding and you have to go in with your partner and do a dance. You ever done that? That was challenging.
That is so
the best one so far.
The spinnies. Spinnies.
I kind of want to learn some of this.
All right. I don't know if we can keep doing this. This is great, though. Let me hear the song again, though.
Ridiculous.
Okay. Let's move along. But every time I play that, it makes me smile.
I think the building burned down that night, and there were a lot of deaths. Make it real, Chris.
Okay, sorry.
I just had to go there for a minute. I know it's not paranormal.
Okay, yeah. Why were we even doing? You totally distracted me from what we were doing.
We were doing Reiki stuff, and then wasn't there
Reiki stuff?
Rake.
Oh, Rake, yeah. Yeah, okay, so we do have one, actually. This is a really popular video. Let's get to it here.
Is this the man outside his backyard?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now imagine this. Imagine if you were on your circle, Brian, you're out there, your small town, you're on your street, your childhood home. And at night you see out your window, this Fantastic.
Oh yeah, this one is pretty good. Even Fantastic. Though it may not be, it's still pretty creepy.
I like this one. This is pretty shocking.
Just imagine this happening.
I have a hard time believing it's real, but if it is,
just put yourself in this situation. Yeah. Just imagine that it is real.
So in this scene, this guy, he is calling a friend on the phone. It's basically saying it's back, I think, if I remember correctly. And I think they're both religious, pretty religious, not fundamentalist, but very very spiritual, I think.
They
it sounds
talk about
like
it's a demon.
They start saying Lord's Prayer. Right. So,
the power
you know,
of Christ compels
this is
you.
From someone named Rick Grebenick, which is an awesome name.
Grebenick. What? He's not a patron.
No, not yet.
Not yet.
Might be after this.
No.
Well, before Jeremy gets back here to control panel me back to the video here, do you guys have any weird things that happened to you? We were going to set up a call-in line. I don't think we have it ready.
No, we weren't going to do that tonight. Remember we said we were going to wait? Yeah, the next episode.
Right.
Next stream.
Yeah, so probably the end part of the episode, maybe the last half an hour, we're going to have call-ins like we did on our first live stream that we tried out. It'll all be set up. You can call in a number.
You got any stories?
Yeah. And we're probably going to keep it to like a 5-minute mark to chat and then go to the next person. Because last time I think we had some people trying to get in. And, you know, it's hard to know when to be like, all right, we'll talk to you later.
Yeah, but that's not till next episode. So.
Right. But get ready.
Are
get ready
waiting
with your
for
stories.
Jeremy to.
Yeah, I hear you. All right. Jer, will you launch me over to my screen here? Mr. Miller? Miller Lightman?
I can always just go.
Dude.
Okay, whoa. That's good, John.
Whoa.
All right, here we are. This is Evil Creature caught on tape by Rick Grebenick. Nice. Preview the program.
Hey, Mickey G.
Hey, Mike, I need you.
Hey, can I hear you?
Can you hear me now?
Can
you hear me now?
A little bit, yeah.
All right, you're not going to believe this. I got it on video now. People think I'm nuts. It's on video. It's playing right now. I put the iPad in the window, and now this thing's coming up to the steps in my backyard, mm-hmm. Mike.
What's coming up?
It's like a weird, demonic-looking thing, and it's like a human, and it's all scratched down. And this is the second time this happened this week.
Right.
And as I'm talking to you, this is all on recorded. And it doesn't see me. I'm in that, you know, that sunroom.
Uh-huh.
All right. I've been putting the iPad out. It's about around, and it happened. It's weird things been happening around this time at night.
Can I record it?
You're on record. It's everything's recording now. It's. I can see the
That's
thing. It's like darker. Looking around weird.
Is it recording the video?
To me, like.
Yeah, right now. It's on the video.
It's obviously humanoid.
It doesn't see me.
Shape. Why wouldn't you call the police?
I'm sitting back, but I can still see out the window.
Because he
knows
it's a demon.
Well, he's supposedly seen it in the past.
No, it can't, but it's looking around.
Did you call
the
police then?
Something out of a weird sci-fi movie. This thing is freaky.
Oh.
It's on video. Huh?
I'm going to skip ahead a little bit.
No, it's an evil.
We can on our screen, but
evil.
Here, John.
The studio monitor is dark.
Like wicked looking.
Careful, Jer.
But it's a human
form. I
know
it gets closer towards the end.
Yeah, I'm going to skip ahead a little bit.
I got
cool
it on
that.
Video.
So he's sitting back right now, right? Yeah, he's in his sunroom.
I think he might be upstairs or something.
Yeah, wherever he is, he's not like right there. I think he's. Oh, so this is like a security camera?
Yeah.
Oh,
he
I was
said
thinking
it's an iPad.
Or it's his iPad and he can see it, I think, at a distance. It's really kind of a complex story. old guy. But yeah, I mean, definitely. You could easily say hoax.
I want to see when it gets closer.
Okay, he's getting closer.
It's a play,
hey, John.
The way it moves is pretty creepy.
Looking out.
Backyard?
Yeah, on the right side, there's the weeds there going down that sidewalk.
Looks a lot of shape.
I got it on. I got it on everything.
Looks like gorilla-like. Or
and you're and
simian.
Everything
it's naked.
The whole thing right now. It's the iPad's recording everything.
Could be a crazy
you
person
this thing.
Covered in like powder.
And I don't know. I should. What's the police gonna think?
I mean, if it is real,
it's looking. Oh
pretty
my god!
Creepy.
Gosh.
How slowly
oh
it's coming up. Like,
dude, this thing is weird. Just.
Sure it's not somebody should call the police.
Yeah. No. It's a demonic creature.
That's
no. We're not
gonna
call the cops.
That's what's weird to me. Even if it's obviously physically there.
Yeah.
Call the police anyway. Even if it's a demonic monster.
Well, he doesn't want his friend to get caught.
If exactly. It's a hoax, he doesn't want his friend in the
maybe
suit to get caught.
He fears for the policeman's life.
Yeah, I don't think so. Yeah, I mean.
And it goes back. It just went back. It
you know, it moves kind of weird. It's all obviously all like.
Doesn't it come right up to the screen?
Yeah, I think it's as far as close as it gets.
It.
I think.
No, it gets closer. Back
in the I'm gonna definitely.
Think people, yeah, like it. No.
I'll skip ahead here. People have zoomed in. Oh, that's where he's praying. That guy's praying for him. Man, if I was his friend, I'd be in the car driving over there.
No, you wouldn't.
Yeah, I would. Not if like your
if
favorite
my friend called and was like, "Hey, I think there's a demonic creature coming to the, you're gonna. I'm gonna go him over."
I think it'd be more beneficial than
he
just
might,
saying a prayer from my condo
his friend
10
might,
miles away.
His friend might not even believe him and might just be saying a prayer to make him feel better. You know, yeah. Like his friend's kind of crazy potentially.
I mean, yeah. Obviously this thing is real. Whatever it is, I mean,
thought it got closer than that.
This is one of those things.
There. Oh, that. Okay. There's
oh,
a better
stands up.
Image here.
Oh, it stands up here.
My gosh.
I command you to go in Jesus' name.
This thing is looking weird. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. It knows something's going on, man. This thing is. Oh my gosh.
Oh no. In tongues. It's working. It's an ad for the local church.
Yeah,
yeah, I mean,
no.
This is
kind
of
interesting.
This is
it's
one of those experiences, or this is one of those videos where it's either if you don't believe, then this is so dumb. It's obviously some guy painted up or whatever,
right.
Moving weird. And then if you want to believe in like skinwalkers or rakes or demons, whatever you want to call them, then it's a really interesting piece of footage, right?
Right.
I think without more information, it's really hard to know.
Right.
It's either really good
it's
evidence or
discredit.
It's definitely
yeah,
totally
can't, a fake.
You can't jump to the conclusion that it's real.
Yeah, let's see some of the comments here.
Vengo a ver las pesos prohibitos? I don't know.
Oh, the YouTube comments?
Yeah, no. What do people say in the chat? My guess is that most people don't think this is legit, but who knows? We are in the belief hole. Aaron Harmon was trying to zoom in to see if it has a penis. That would be a good piece of evidence right there.
Dong da dong dong.
Yeah. What's Dear David? People are saying.
Oh, Dear David.
What do you think of the Dear David video?
Dear David.
That's not the pencil thing. That's
no,
Charlie.
Dear David was a. I think it started with a guy. I want to say he was on. He had a Twitter account. He was also like a blogger, or he wrote. He was a journalist of some kind, and then started. What I thought, if I remember it correctly, it was sort of an elaborate, like over a period of time, he would write these updates on what was going on in his home with this Dear David figure. And I'm pretty sure it came out that he was just making it up. But
is there a video or anything? Or is
I don't
story?
Remember there being a video, but maybe he might have tweeted a video. I think it was on Twitter. Let me double check. Dear David.
I guess I could check it on YouTube and see if there is a...
Is this someone recommended watching this in the stream?
Someone just had mentioned... who was that? Emily McMahon, what do you guys think about the Dear David thing?
I mean, I've seen a lot of people cover it. The reason why we didn't on our show was because from what I had seen, it seemed like it was the guy had fabricated it to tell a good story. But I could be wrong.
Could be.
I could look into it again.
Yeah, Sunny L said, Dear David was fun for a long time. Meaning maybe it came out that it was fake.
It was, he did it in a good, I mean, it was one of these things where it was constantly being updated, like every other week or so.
Trying to remember this.
There would be a recent update.
What was the story exactly? So it was a...
These things where it was constantly being oops, updated. Sorry.
Was it a haunting or something?
I can play some of the videos if you want.
There would be a
my bad, sorry.
Let's see if I can find the videos. It's hard to find the, okay. Adam Ellis, yeah, that was the guy, I think. Or unless it's a guy who just retweeted it, but I think this might be the guy. It sounds right.
Yeah, it sounds like it was fake.
From just gauging the conversation chat.
I forget the story. Maybe someone can write in. I forget what it was supposed to be. It was a kid who had like a dented head. It was like an apparition of a kid who had died or something. Mm. And there was some sort of Bloody Mary element to it, if I remember correctly. Something that like you... Like he left messages, or if you said certain things like Dear David, yeah, it's been,
okay.
I mean, this came out a while ago, so I don't remember the details, but I remember being,
it's a viral ghost story.
Yeah. It was more of like an invented creepypasta, if I remember correctly. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure. Dear David, documenting the ghost in my apartment. Yeah, it sounds like a kind of a creative project. I mean, the drawing of it. Is this this is the thing. Okay, Adam Ellis, if he created... Yeah.
He's also an author.
He's in an illustrator. I mean, the illustration of this thing is like... It looks like he's taking a kind of a cool graphic novel children's story and making it kind of a live art piece and making it live on Twitter in that sense.
Here, go over to my screen real quick. I've got an article here. This is from The Sun.
Okay. Do you have this image?
This one, Chris?
I had it.
Do you have this image?
But
the cartoon? We'll get there. We'll get there.
Okay. It's a good drawing. It's a good drawing. All right. Preview to program.
You don't have to say that. You know, it's not like a spell.
Preview to program.
Okay. Night Scare Before Christmas is the proof, dear date. Is this proof Dear David is fake? John,
what?
You're a sound guy. You don't need to eat snacks on the microphone.
Snack?
ASMR.
Dear David, is Dear David fake? Fans of bloke who's shared videos of the ghost in his home are convinced the latest clip went too far. Adam Ellis, who has been tweeting updates of ghostly goings-ons in his flat in New York, may have gone too far this time. The cartoonist and illustrator has won more than 725,000 followers since he started live tweeting spooky happenings in August. Each update scored him a wider audience, and many people were clearly ready to believe it was true. That's a sad state. That's I feel like I'm that a lot of the time.
What?
What do you
like?
Saying?
Ready to believe? You know, like
right. Okay.
This week he returned to Twitter, apologizing for a fortnight's absence, as he said he has been struggling to sleep and has had weird dreams and sudden dizzy spells. Look at that face.
That's a fierce sucker
very
mouth.
Manicured. He said instead of waking up one night last week, quote, there was this a tangible feeling of badness. That is a weird quote. Okay, so these are some of his tweets here. There's what I felt that night, malice, dread, but still I was alone. And I was so tired. I wound up just going back to sleep. I've been so exhausted recently, I can barely function. Then December 12th, I guess same day, it was a feeling, I guess this is what you have to do. It was a feeling I'm used to. It always accompanies David. People tweeted me a lot saying he might just need help, but I'm certain that's not the case. Every time he shows up, I feel a palpable sense of malice. Still, there was this tangible feeling of badness. Everything felt wrong, sort of like when you have the flu and you wake up at night and can't really tell where you are for a minute. But last week, John.
Sorry, I'm hungry.
Prepare your food in baggies. Oh, well.
But last week, something started to happen. Late on Wednesday, I woke up with a start and felt something strange, like something had just been watching me. I turned on the light, but I was alone. Then suddenly he was there, standing on the chair at the foot of the bed, staring at me. Is this supposed to, that's supposed to be him. Oh, is there a bigger picture?
Oh, is this what went too far?
Oh, probably.
Because it was a fake image or something?
So this is supposed to be him here?
Spoiled his ghost story by trying to make it real.
Let's click on the pictures here. I don't know how the Twitter works.
Pinch your zoom on your Mac, Chris. Pinch and zoom. Pinch and spread.
I'm out of it. I don't know. It's
well done.
I'm back in it.
Okay. I don't like this stuff, man. I know that like people like creepypastas and stuff. I just don't like when it's mixed with reality. Like they're trying to, you know. Hi, John.
Hi.
It's an intense face. Like when people are using it to get attention, get more followers, and it, yeah, I just it hate fake clouds. Shit so bad.
Well, here, let's go back.
It's so frustrating when there's so much, like, compelling information out there and compelling evidence, and then there's someone, like, you know,
if you look at this,
something.
I'll put this in the notes of this cast, but...
Very unhappy.
If you look, and go back to my screen for 1 second, Jared, there is a lot of... he's posted a lot of videos and pictures of alleged evidence of Dear David in his apartment, and here's one video. Different pictures and video. We're not going to cover all these right now. It'd be interesting to do just because people have done it. Okay, so this is the alleged, did he go too far? Like, okay, this appeared, he got this picture. So he's been...
Looks like a doll.
John, check this out.
It's hard to see up there.
Oh, yeah, I guess hard to see on the screen. He's been collecting these accounts that's been going on in his apartment, and then finally he gets this shot, and the best evidence of any ghost ever would be if it was real. Pretty unbelievable.
But yeah, we'll link these in there. And here's a video. Are you turning the brightness, Jer? Here is a video of what Adam Ellis believes is a spooky evidence of his chair moving. It's proof of the paranormal in his apartment. Let's see what happens here. After an ad from Spectrum. Oops, I clicked on the ad. Okay. Really? Okay. I apologize for the ad there. We got 3 seconds left. Here we go.
Probably turn the sharpness up a little bit.
All right, so this chair is going to move, I'm guessing. Okay, it starts to rock here.
Okay, just sit down, Jer. Well, that's creeps.
Okay, I mean, so he claims, or we'll start from the beginning here. This is, he tweeted this as evidence that paranormal activity is
there's burning. A skull above it.
Creepy.
So watch, it's going to rock. I mean, that's so easily done with a string. Not to say that that's what's going on, but I, you know.
Yeah, not hard to fake that.
No, it's a rocking chair. Anything else happen? Does anything appear on the chair? Okay.
Oh, there. Look at the chair now.
Wait, is something... Oh, there it goes again. Okay, I mean, yeah. I don't know the story enough. I think, if anything, it's probably a fun story. Because I've heard other people cover it.
It's not
it.
Fun.
I mean, it's a fun, it's fictitious serious. Story, as far as I know.
I don't like it. I just don't like that you can go for, what, weeks posting tweets about something allegedly happening that's completely fake.
Yeah,
you know, and I don't know, it's just I don't like mixing. I get it, like it's an art piece, it's creative or whatever,
it makes it's frustrating for people like you guys out there and people like us who are interested in the reality of this stuff. I mean, it's fun for a lot of people, I think, because the creepypasta thing in general I think is fun for a lot, and it's weird because I think back on growing up with things like Scary Stories and Goosebumps, well, that's, I guess, everything. Yeah,
but you knew it was.
But I enjoyed the fiction of it. And the older I got and the more we looked into it as a possible reality, the less I was interested in the fictitious storytelling of the stuff. Although I do still...
Even Scary Stories.
I still enjoy, like, fiction. Like, I love Stephen King.
Right.
But when it comes to the blurring, which is what is such a common thing now, the creepypasta, blurring the fiction with the reality... I think that does a disservice to people who are kind of like we were talking with Pat last night about conspiracy. Mm-hmm. And you blur the fiction into the conspiracy, and then you start to it's easier to discredit the people who are looking at things seriously. Uh-huh. And say, like, well, you're the most extreme, unbacked conspiracy.
And that mixed with the fact that everyone has a camera, everyone can upload. So it's just this, you know,
it's a constant stream of information, so much misinformation. Yeah. And so a lot of it's innocent. A lot of it's people just trying to have fun. But it frustrates me because I think if you are interested in this stuff and you think that it's important, then it's frustrating because,
right.
You know.
Well, here, okay, this is a good example. Because I think about this all the time. Like, man, I've seen so many bad hoaxes or decent hoaxes, but to me, like, they're just obvious hoaxes.
Right.
Where I thought, like, oh, it comes from this channel. Like the one we did earlier, the Skinwalker Scream.
Yeah.
That comes from Mr. Big Dill or something, Mr. Dill. We'll have it linked in the show notes. But I clicked on his channel and his icon is like an alien head, and then he's doing like paranormal news, and he just happened to catch this Skinwalker Scream and that maniacal laughter in his backyard.
Oh, right.
And it makes me so angry. It doesn't make me angry, but I just think it's gross.
I think it makes you angry.
If we were to make like a video as like a hoax for fun,
let's do it right.
Well, yeah, make it really good. But, you know,
I would never
to attach something like that to our show.
Yeah.
And try to get viewers that way. It just seems so disingenuous.
Oh,
there's a lot of karma coming back.
Wouldn't you feel gross?
Oh yeah.
Like I would feel gross, and I would feel like, yeah.
Everything else I said
too.
Is everything else I say
so
after
dishonest.
That is it's suspect. Every comment I make, every thought I have is suspect. So like, am I just trying to get?
How can you take yourself seriously? But I guess I mean, that's the thing. I feel like, how can you do both?
Get those clicks, man.
Yeah. I don't. I don't know. Yeah. Everybody has their own life experience.
Bothers the creeps out of me, man.
Bothers the creeps right out of me.
Let's go to some comments before we do the next video.
Let's go to comments. You know, I can pop comments up there, guys.
Yeah, I want to see them. I want to see what's going on in the feed.
It's your moment, guys.
It's your moment to let us know how you feel.
It's your time
it's
in
your
the
moment
sun.
To let us know how you feel. It's your moment. All right.
To let us know how you feel. I was just getting in on it.
You're chanting, right. Ray.
Ray, you're chanting. All right, popping out the chat. Okay. Comments are... All right, do you see any interesting here you want to read?
Totally.
We're on a delay, guys, just so you know.
Totally agree with Chris. Thank you, Tammy. Most people should. In my humble opinion,
I would feel betrayed. Yeah, absolutely.
Exactly. Yes.
What do they agree with you for?
I agree with Jennifer. Says I agree with Jeremy. It cheapens the true stories. Creepypasta is one thing, and then there's people faking things on Twitter for attention or fame. Absolutely. Yeah. You're hitting the nail on the head there. It's just frustrating. I mean, I don't like to disparage people, but you know what? I do. I think in this case, it's fair because you're doing it to mislead people.
Good and gather, Petra. That's what I'm drinking.
I don't think she's asking you what you're drinking.
She said, John, are you still not drinking?
Drinking. She wants you to drink with her, John.
Yeah, I like my...
John, no, this is a good John. This crazy John, I think, is a good John.
It's good level John.
Drinking, well, we've had our debates when we've, like, early,
yeah.
If we're all drinking...
Good night, Beth, sweet dreams.
It can get intense.
Night, Beth, thanks for hanging out.
Aaron, that's how they get you, Ray.
That's how they get you,
great
Ray.
Great Burbs response. conspiracy stuff, Lauren M. says. Oh, boy.
Brian King.
Brian Kinkleberry's in here. Dina says hi.
Hey, Dina.
Happy birthday, Dina.
Happy birthday, Dina.
We both have Brian childhood friends, and they're both in the chat. Beth, we skipped over Beth. She said, guys, it's been a blast yet again, but I've hit my 2 a.m. Oh, she's saying goodnight.
I thought she said something that was a question. All right, Beth.
You're awesome too, Beth.
Get out of here.
Thanks a lot. Hey, thanks for coming, Beth.
Yeah, sweet dreams. We appreciate you being
sweet
here.
Sweet dream.
Dream of
who says Jeremy's crazy gal. Corner? Jeremy's Zach.
Yeah. Oh, Zach. Zachy D.
Totally be a segment. Yeah,
we talked about that. Actually, John, last night, John said he was going to develop a stinger for specifically Jeremy's crazy corner. And then,
but I didn't want to do it.
Yeah, he needs a little preparation.
Yeah, because I don't want to. It's not just like random thoughts. It's research. It's based on compelling arguments of the bizarre.
It would
and
be
strange.
Fun to do like that for the show, but also like during a live stream. I think it might even be more fun.
I think it'd be more fun because if you notice, when Jeremy does an episode, it's all images that he tries to convey on audio.
It's maps.
It's maps.
Images and maps.
It's mountains or giants.
Well, the worm knights or the night worms, however you want to call them, that's visual. I'd like to show some visual evidence of the worm knight existence.
Philadelphia experiment. Did we cover that at all? I feel like we touched on that in previous episodes. We could do a
not
deeper
really.
Dive.
We've never covered that strongly.
I did I think it was an expansion. No. Oh, you know what? I prepped it for the, we did the Fortean fog and strange miss episode.
The Philadelphia experiment.
Right. I prepped it for, because I was going to include it in the Fortean fog episode, the expansion episode, mysterious mist, because there was a green mist involved. So I started doing a lot of background on the Philadelphia experiment.
Oh, sorry. He followed up with how about Project Bluebeam? That's something we've been talking about.
Yeah.
That seems like it might
John's
be more
a little
and more
conspiracy Googleizer.
All this disclosure nonsense. Who was I talking to? I was just talking to someone about
nonsense.
Who was that? Bailey. She sent in the alien footage that we haven't put out yet. But she mentioned like the we got into talking about Dr. Stephen Greer and how all aliens are good guys.
Yeah.
You know that idea that like and he's such a prima donna.
Oh gosh.
No offense, Dr. Greer. He's, you know,
I do love that guy, but he is.
He's. I wouldn't call him a narcissist, but he just has that like attention.
He's got that shield, that kind of I don't know, a self defense mechanism up a lot. It feels like he's kind of shielded, and sometimes I feel like he's defending himself before he's attacked. I don't know. I mean, I'm totally
can I play a clip of him in case people don't know who he is?
Yeah, play some Dr. Greer.
I met him in real life.
You did. That was randomly. Amazing. Yeah. What did you say to him? You found it was Enchanted Rock outside of Austin, Texas.
Yeah.
Right? And what did you say? You just happened to bump
into
him.
No, he saw Jake.
Oh, your dog. Yeah.
And he was like, "Oh, dog!" And he like, I was like, "Oh, you can't get too close." And then I was like, "You're fucking Stephen Greer." And he was like, "Yes, I am." And then he had like a group of people that they were all at Enchanted Rock to look for UFOs.
Yeah.
And they had the one guy showed me some pictures and they were weird.
Yeah. I mean, I think they definitely do like as much as I think that stuff is kind of strange and it's a money grab a little bit. I do think they get, I don't know, they get results.
Well, for those of you who don't know who Dr. Greer is, he actually, I think the most beneficial thing he did was the Disclosure Project. I mean, he brought all these people together, government officials, former NASA employees, current Defense Department officials, it was at least 100 people that came and maybe not that all came and testified at Congress, but that he had submit these affidavits of what they experienced, of definite evidence of extraterrestrial contact and influence in our country and around the world. Incredible. If you haven't seen it, we back then it was, you know, DVDs still. We actually bought the DVDs.
Because it was a big deal when that came out.
It happened right before 9/11, like the day before or something.
Right.
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so no one heard about it.
That's crazy.
It came out.
I have those on DVD.
Incredible stuff. If you want to see, you should probably find some on YouTube now, but man, that really blows the top of things. So whatever you want to say about Dr. Stephen Greer, because he definitely,
he's a bit of a,
Madonna. Is it, or prima donna? Is that what
I refer to him as? He's a very special kind of special, like in the sense that
he has a big personality, and he's been able to like do a lot with that personality.
Right, the briefings of presidents.
I think what makes him eke up on people's like BS meter a little bit is that he, and I don't think this is altogether something you can throw out as completely woo, but it sounds like woo or whatever. But the idea that he can summon UFOs. Like, right. It started as he was someone who allegedly briefed.
Well, he's not
presidents.
The only person that says that.
No, I know. That's what I'm saying. There's other people
it's that through said, consciousness, which there right. is some, like, validity to that.
No, I agree. I've heard enough.
But it is pretty accounts. Woo. I mean, yeah. You got to admit it.
It's the wooest of woo.
It's the wooest of woo.
You can summon extraterrestrial people craft have done, by your intention.
Remember that guy on the news channel? They interviewed this guy. I think it's in outside Houston, Texas or something. And he supposedly could like summon UFOs just with his consciousness or something. And he would just.
Yeah, they had like a news person.
They had a
like
news person come out to like basically debunk
him.
And then the guy comes out. We could probably find that clip.
Yeah.
Comes
and then
out.
They
and
were
then,
actually
and
UFOs.
It's like it comes up live on the news.
Yeah.
It was pretty crazy.
What was that?
I forget his name. I want to say his name's like Rainmaker Smith or something. But that's probably
that's
not
close.
Anywhere close. But real quick.
Rainmaker Smith.
Real quick in the chat here. Elena Stedman brings up a point that's kind of catching on fire. Actually, this is an article that we prepared for the show that we haven't got into yet. But she said, guys, I mentioned this earlier, but I'm surprised you haven't mentioned the new CIA UFO document drop. They
yeah,
released
I have
early.
It up here. I have it ready to go.
Yeah. Said they released over 700 documents.
There's not much to it. Well, yeah, it's because people haven't really fully explored it, right?
Yeah. Again,
we should read the article about the CD-ROM, which is just weird.
All right. You sent that to me, right, Jer?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I did.
Well, I put it on the documents.
I did it.
I didn't want to read from Jezebel.
Yeah.
So I found this similar article from a different
The name Jezebel is dirty in itself.
The name is dirty.
Well, Jezebel means like...
Oh, is that biblical?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that's funny.
For sure. It's like a F-U to the Bible, pretty much.
F-U what? Bible, I'm Jezebel.
Oh, baloney.
It's a character in the Bible.
I know.
Yeah, but it's supposed to be like... I don't know. Is she related to Lilith in some way? I don't know.
She was not...
She was like, just like a harlot or something, wasn't she?
Yeah, but she did some bad things, I think.
A lot of people in the Bible did some bad things.
Well, let's read.
So did Paul. He was Saul, okay?
Did you send that to me, Jer?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's in the notes.
Oh, it is? You have in the notes? Okay.
Yeah.
Well, it looks like...
It's the third. It's the third link under news.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Jezebel, according to the narrative, along with her husband, instituted the worship of Baal.
Oh yeah.
And so
Baal.
On a national scale, that's crazy. Right. Baal is a demon.
Yeah. What was they would sacrifice
children. Yeah. So she wasn't the nicest of people.
No, she was a horrible person.
And that's what they named it that because
that's so bizarre that you would name your. I mean, if they could maybe.
Well, if it's like one of the
Jezebel. I don't know, I feel like
it's meant. I think to like.
Stir you up.
Antagonize Christianity.
Oh, like, right.
Because that's kind of their opposite viewpoint of the world is they don't
well,
like
it's,
that.
Well, it's weird
so.
Because like outside of Christianity, even as a human, that the
child sacrifice isn't cool.
Well, the worship of Baal was a real thing, not just biblical.
Right.
And the sacrificing of children is a real thing. Was back then, at least for sure. And the worship of Baal was part, that was part of the worship. So it is weird to name your publication after
they're trying to
sacrifice.
Be
it's
gonna
be sensational
nasty.
It's Baal
it is a little sensational
B-A apostrophe A.
All right, so this is from Live Science. CIA releases entire collection.
Wait, let me get this on screen here.
Okay,
I'll be Picard on screen.
Engage CIA releases entire. Oh boy,
zoom that in.
I should probably full screen this, sorry guys.
A little ASMR for you. Zoom in.
Oh, I just minimized it.
It's creepy. Okay, John, please stop.
You're not even drinking. No excuse.
No, lots of excuses.
Why are you on Patreon?
I went to the wrong page. Here we go. CIA releases entire collection of UFO-related documents to truth-seeking website. Wait, what? They released it to a random website?
Did they release it to Black Vault?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they did. Black Vault is... They've been doing a lot of great stuff for a long time.
Oh, okay.
They do a lot of FOIA requests, Freedom Information Act.
FOIA?
Oh. Freedom Information Act requests where they... there's like the whole MK Ultra. A lot of the stuff we got from MK Ultra was because of Black Vault.
There was a CIA dump last year. It was that's where a lot of the MK Ultra stuff, Wormwood stuff came out.
Well, and here's my question when it comes to this stuff too, is like, and we talked about this recently on with regard to release information.
Going. Yeah. Like what is misinformation? What is there? Are they going to really give you everything?
How do we know what they're giving us is just because we requested it and it's legally binding? Are there people from independent factions, citizens, you know, going in, you know, overseeing this, doing, you know, like a vote count kind of thing, like watching over the shoulder of like what information are they giving us?
Right.
Or is it just like, well, we have to give them something.
Well, let's tell the story. Let's read the article here.
All right. Preview to program.
You don't have to say
it. I like saying it.
Okay. The Black Vault documents cover everything from mysterious Russian explosions to top government officials being hand-delivered UFO intel. More than three decades worth of government UFO records are now yours to download and pursue. Oh, well, let me go ahead and command-tab that. Thanks to the efforts of some intrepid truth seekers, the massive data dump includes more than 2,700 pages of UFO-related documents declassified by the CIA since the 1980s. The U.S. Okay, so they skip Roswell and all the other good stuff. The U.S. government also calls them, quote, unidentified aerial phenomena. Yeah, that's what we know now, right? UAP.
Right.
According to Black Vault, an online repository of UFO-related documents operated by author John Greenwald Jr. The documents were obtained through a long string of Freedom of Information Act requests filed over the last quarter century. Over time, so many requests piled up that the CIA created a CD-ROM. John, this is what you're saying. Ridiculous.
Right.
Full of declassified documents known as the UFO collection. Not even a DVD, a data DVD, a CD-ROM.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I present to you Ridiculousness. And he recently finished uploading its contents
cool
as a
label,
series
though.
Of searchable PDF files on his website. Okay, so John, according to this article, you can actually go to this dude's website, and that's a resource where you can search these files.
Black Vault, I think, archived all of it digitally.
Yeah, you can find them at the Black Vault. The documents cover dozens of incidents, including the 1976 account of the government's then Assistant Deputy Director of Science and Technology being hand-delivered a mysterious piece of intelligence on a UFO to the description of a mysterious midnight explosion. And okay, this gets,
gets in the weeds a bit.
Although the CIA claims this is their entire declassified collection, there may be no way to entirely verify that. You think? Greenwald wrote in a statement on the Black Vault website, research by the Black Vault will continue to see if there are, okay. I mean, it's cool. And it'll be interesting to dig into like what are some of the things that came out. The last CIA dump was fascinating because there were some interesting things, accounts in there. But
yeah,
at the end of the day, I mean, I guess you have to think, what do you believe? Do you believe that they want to disclose this information slowly? Is it a slow drip like we've talked about? Or is this more of a, you know, they're just not going to give you the real juicy juice,
Real juicy juice.
Like, what do you think? I mean, that's what it comes down to. I guess it comes down to what you personally believe the motives are for this release. I mean, obviously, there wasn't so much pressure. I mean, I guess you could lump this into what was that recent that was pumped into that COVID bill about having to release all the alien or all the UFO or UAP-related evidence that Pentagon had or something, mm-hmm. and they snuck that into the bill, so allegedly they had to release it. I guess you could argue that maybe this is part of that.
Well, okay, this goes back to whoever brought up the idea of Project Bluebeam. Right.
Yeah.
Like, okay, if you want to present a people with a particular idea of what's going on with UAPs, UFOs, and the alien extraterrestrial reality, the best way I feel like to dump a lot of disinfo on them because if the government came out and just said like, "Hey guys, it's Thursday. By the way, aliens are real, and we made a deal with them with Eisenhower, you know, shortly before or after Roswell, whatever," that would be suspect. But if someone slips in a Freedom of Information Act or a clause in a bill, how do you get that through? What a hero to put that in. Now I guess we have to give you all this information that we wanted to give you to shape your idea of the extraterrestrial reality. This is the Project Bluebeam idea. The idea being that they create
the narrative they want you to follow, basically. Yeah. It happens all the time with the government.
Right.
That's what they do.
It's problem, reaction, solution. They create this is the theory. They create a reality about an extraterrestrial threat or an extraterrestrial, you know, brotherhood coming together. Whatever it is, either way. Project Bluebeam, I think, is usually the threat aspect.
No, I think it's coming together under one new religion.
Or it could
well,
be...
Well, yeah, no, what I'm saying is because of the threat, there's a coming together.
Oh, I thought... Are you sure? Because I thought it was like... they.
Project Blue Beam, what I thought was that it was like, I thought it had more to do with like all religions. Like everyone's religious figure was in the sky and they all came together.
Oh, like in some like sky orgy?
That's what, it was basically they all form into one new.
Oh, see, okay, I don't know. I've never
maybe
heard anything
that
specific.
Maybe that's not it. Maybe, my idea, I thought that was it though, but I'm not sure.
My idea was the Ronald Reagan thing, which was like, you know, I sometimes think how we'd respond if there was a great, you know, extraterrestrial threat, essentially. And that idea of like, well, we all have to come together, one world government, to be as strong as we can against an invading force, right? Yep. That idea of Project Bluebeam. And it could go either way. You could have a positive or a negative Project Bluebeam type scenario, but basically the idea is that it is fictitiously created for a response,
right?
For us to all give up our freedoms, give up you know, our autonomy, so that we can either join in or fight back against this greater threat outside,
you know,
of those that are trying to control us right here at home.
It might be fun to do a series of project episodes. Project Pegasus, Project Bluebeam, Project
MKUltra.
What was the one we talked about earlier? Manhattan Project. It might be fun to do that. Just do a series on those. Maybe a documentary series. That
Project
kinda...
Corona.
Project Corona. I'm sure it has a different name. Good night, Patra. Oh, whose mouth was that?
What? That sound?
I think it was from Jeremy's inside.
That's my microphone.
All right, let's go to the comments. You guys want to talk about anything? Now that we're kind of, I mean, we've got other videos we can play, but.
I think we're kind of like, I think we're winding down. Wind down and just see what if anyone else has anything else to bring up. Or... Yeah.
Well, Jennifer said on that last note, we talked about Project Bluebeam. It's a good way to direct the narrative in their favor. They give a bit of the truth. Yeah, always true. You have a bit of the truth to make it seem more honest, but it's only a partial truth, and we can't know how much of it to trust.
That's how lies, when it comes to these big manipulation games, it's the ones that work best are the ones that mix a lot of truth, and then they change the things they want to. So they lay some truth. Same thing happened with this Q thing, the QAnon
thing.
This
was what I was talking with Pat last night. You know, we were talking about conspiracy theory.
People fell for that hard.
When I was talking to Pat last night, we were saying how, like, really when it comes down to, and one of the reasons why Pat wants to do his thesis on this, John, is that the people are beginning to conflate, and I think have for a while, but with the appearance of QAnon, any conspiracy theorist, once you start something like QAnon, then it's like, well, he's a conspiracy theorist, so he believes everything.
What did Twitter just do? Twitter just banned 70,000 accounts that have posted Q adjacent posts.
Right.
So that could be like
any conspiracy theory,
anything, or even conservative that has to do with something about Trump or something, because it's Q adjacent.
Yeah, but I'm talking specifically.
It just
about
seems like a total setup. So like it was almost perfectly done, so they could get everyone under one crazy umbrella.
Yeah. Right. Well, that's what I'm saying.
What do they call that? Provocateur. I always forget that term.
Agent provocateur.
Yeah. Right. You get someone in front to start the riot, and then people join in.
From the very beginning, when the Q stuff started happening, to me it felt like that. It felt like someone's taking every known conspiracy theory that has validity to it, and then writing fiction around it, and then trolling people with this information to make people believe that this is some magical narrative that's going on. And then so you devalue anybody who's looking into legit conspiracies.
And you also distract 80 million people, or how many people, you know, fell for it. It's like, instead of actually, because it started with, like, a lot of it was based on, like, child trafficking.
Right,
which is
a real thing. Yeah.
That's how they get people, like, hooked, and then they... Yeah. Take them down some other, and so instead of actually focusing
once
on
they
things
start
that,
making prophecies and start like claiming there's godly figures and stuff, like that's gotta be a red flag.
Making like big predictions that never come true, and they keep stringing.
Just wait,
people
a, wait
along.
2 weeks, they'll be, you know,
right. And people still think that like something's gonna happen before the election or before the Biden gets sworn in. Mm-hmm. Like there's like 4 days left. People still think that they're gonna get arrested, like all, you know, these people in Washington that are career.
And that's
criminals.
That's why I feel like it could totally be a government run misinformation campaign.
Oh, it's a psyop
to just create more division for people.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's sad.
It's divide and conquer.
Anyway, I forgot where we were, but let's go back to the comments. We are wrapping up.
Yeah, they're discussing the basically the idea of like the extraterrestrials. Are they good or bad?
Right. If there are extraterrestrials, I got to think it's both.
Yeah, right.
Just like there's good and bad people in the world.
I would think so.
And one other thing that's interesting about...
I think if they're taking you, though, I don't think it's beneficial.
I don't
think it's nice.
I don't think so either.
Without your permission.
It's for your own good.
I think
I think one of the reasons there could, if there is extraterrestrial life in the universe, which seems like it's a high probability. Okay. but, you know, I hear people say when I've had conversations, like, why would anyone want to come here and, like,
it's look, such a dumb argument.
Like, Earth is such, there is life in every nook and cranny of this planet. Like, just endless amounts of life and things going on. Yeah. This would be, like, where everyone would want to.
Yeah, I mean, you can say humans are dumb. Right. Like we make mistakes or whatever. But look at just the ecosystems, the ecology of our planet, like especially in our solar system, we haven't identified other life on other planets. Where we are, assuming other planets exist.
We have like 80 trillion alive things in our own bodies.
Right. And it's so amazing just the cultures on our planet that are so if you're an advanced life form, you'd think that, like, I don't know, hopefully you'd have like the I don't know, emotional and intellectual maturity to look at a different life form that you've never seen before and find it compelling.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
You know, you hear that all the time. You hear like, oh, there's no way if there's something that has advanced space travel, they'd be interested in looking at someone. We'd be like,
yeah,
to them.
Something so less than
that. To me, it's so ridiculous.
We eat a McDonald's.
I love the Gene Roddenberry idea, the Star Trek idea, where you have advanced life forms. Once you discover warp speed or whatever it is, let's see, maybe it's Event Horizon style, maybe it doesn't get you to hell, but like we're at events bend space time and you get to see these other places, maybe in the next 100 years we'll be there. But if that's the case, if we can somehow find a way to travel that fast or fold space time, which isn't completely impossible in the next 100 years, 200 years, we're not gonna be that far away from, I mean, think of how far we've come in the past 200
things
years.
We're expanding exponentially.
Yeah, so imagine if we found a culture that was 200 years previous to us as far as, you know, the exponential growth. Wouldn't you still be interested in what happened to, like, a culture just developed cars?
And not even, you know, just us, but all the other life. We're like a zoo. This planet is like an open source zoo. All, like, even the bacteria, like,
yeah,
viruses, all this stuff, I'm sure is incredibly valuable. If there's other places that have less life, you know, we haven't found anything that has life on it yet.
Right.
But think about like how valuable the minerals.
If we found life, this is the problem. If we found life on another planet, we would have to explain why they haven't been here. And then they'd have to tell us it's because
they have
been here. Earth is the only thing that exists.
Jeremy.
Hey.
No.
Hey.
Crazy corner. What is your thoughts about this?
Jeremy doesn't believe in planets.
He's got to do that. I'm just saying, I'm open.
He's going to do that.
I'm open to the idea.
He's going
to
do it.
I'm open to the idea that, well, I'm open to many ideas. One of those ideas
but
being.
But it seems like you've almost made up your mind.
Because I'm the only one. I'm the only one.
No, I'm just curious. What are you talking about? Are you like certain about this in your mind?
I mean, I haven't been to another planet.
No one has, Jeremy.
No one has.
It sounded like a little child running down.
Someone here?
Anyways.
That was a weird sound. This is, I'd like to know if anyone in the chat is interested in the craziest ideas.
So what, just give a little bit of a description on why that you think that that's probably not likely. What are your thoughts about space?
So I honestly, I understand the science that we have. That we've been told. And are you dancing? What's going to happen now?
I was going to go to the bathroom.
You just literally asked me a question to explain.
John, that was rude. That was rude.
I don't know how many times did like the actual like episode, like podcast episodes, you'll ask me a question. And as soon as I start to respond, his phone comes up.
Because when you're.
It starts checking his credit score.
When you.
When I speak.
When you talk, I get like a glaze in my brain.
Then why ask the question?
I don't know.
You know?
Because I realize as soon as you start talking, I'm like, oh crap. Why did I ask that?
I'll keep it brief. Okay.
What an
I'm
ass.
I'm just joking.
The idea that, like, I know as much as anyone else in my general range of education and intelligence knows about science, about space, about what we've been told about planets, all this stuff. I don't have any proof for
it's
a lot
a
of
very
stuff.
Strong conviction. Because every time we talk about this stuff, you seem
you
to
always
like,
got to mention it. That's
because
the one thing. I think it's equally as for me, it's almost equally as possible
that there is no space. There's
no
planets.
No, no, no,
because
that's
what you. That's essentially what you're saying.
No, I'm
right?
not. No, no, no.
Because when we talk about life from other
planets where
you always have to say if there's.
I'm just saying
space.
No, I never say if there's space.
You say if
space is real.
There's always a caveat.
I'm just
with
saying
you.
I don't believe NASA.
Yeah.
For a lot of reasons.
Well,
yeah,
sure.
So I
did the moon landing episode.
I distrust what they tell us about space, how it, you know, how it exists. I don't, there's problems with the.
You don't even think satellites are real, though.
Well,
there are problems with where they exist in the thermosphere, which where they should be melting or have melted. There's interesting arguments.
There are interesting questions, but I think what bugs me a little bit is that, like, this is the one topic where if we ever start to talk about extraterrestrials, you always have to put the caveat in there.
Because
you always have to have the other argument. It's like, if we did, I don't know.
No, if I'm open to the idea, like, I am.
You spoil all my alien topics with your
baloney. There's so many times I don't bring this stuff up. We did the whole Corey Good episode. Mm-hmm. I never mentioned, you know,
because we had a long talk beforehand.
No, we didn't. I'm just saying, like.
But so I still don't understand. So you think space could be real, right?
It is real.
So, but how do you get from there to, like, there's no possible way there's extraterrestrial life?
Well, he's not
there.
Saying there's no possible.
Okay,
way.
This is what I'm saying. I don't believe necessarily that we've been to space, manned space flight.
Like Apollo moon landings, outside of the atmosphere?
Like Apollo moon landings. Yeah. Right, that's the only
right.
thing.
Well, that's different than being in space.
That's the only thing we've done as far as being in... Well, I guess there's the
International Space Station.
There's a space station, yeah. Which also I think there are problems with.
Right.
I don't.
So you just don't think we've ever made it out of orbit?
Right. And I don't know that we've... Yeah, I mean...
Do you think spacecraft have gone without being manned? Outside
potentially,
of orbit?
Potentially. In our very, very first episode...
Do you think there's some sort of force field that
In our very, very first episode, we talked about that. Remember the dog cam, I think it was called? It was a rocket that went up. Do you remember that? We couldn't play the video because it was just audio. We could play the video now. Maybe we should do that for
the
next live
stream.
It's that video where the rocket goes up and it's going really, really fast. And then all of a sudden it's like it hits something.
Right.
Right as it's
like
breaching
water?
The upper atmosphere. It sounded like it went underwater.
Oh, come on.
I've heard this theory before.
But they didn't know how to explain...
It's like, that's actually water up there.
The firmament, right? Like, I mean, that's biblical. But just the idea that there could be... Like, space could be a kind of ether, a thicker ether, a liquid, if you will. I'm just saying it's not... I don't believe that it is necessarily what they tell us it
is. Totally think that's possible.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know about that theory, but I think there's a lot of things they may not be telling us.
Yeah, and I'm not saying that I believe this... 100% this is true.
Right.
It's just something I like to entertain. So I just I don't like to say it whenever we talk about.
I still don't understand how that eliminates the possible for extraterrestrial
it doesn't.
Life. But you seem to like when we say that it's like
well,
it kind of.
I don't think we have to. If we see something on this planet that we can't explain, I don't think we need to jump to alien.
Jeremy
thinks
interdimensional.
Possible,
I think
Jeremy,
it's possible.
Jeremy
yeah.
thinks more interdimensional.
Right.
Which I think makes sense
if you're
talking about travel.
No one knows for sure.
If you're talking about travel, people always make the argument. The people that don't believe that we're being visited by any sort of otherworldly entity, they always say, well, there's no way that you can travel this many light years. The closest known planet with potential life is so many light years away. I do think that the interdimensional idea explains so much of the alien phenomenon. That doesn't mean that there aren't any aliens coming here from other planets, but I think if I had to guess where extraterrestrial, especially ones that are abducting people, are walking through walls and coming in and doing certain things, if they can do that sort of thing, it seems interdimensional. It seems...
Well, maybe they can be in this dimension and shift dimensionally.
Well, exactly, yeah.
So
but, right, it could be still other planets,
right.
I guess. Or it could be this planet in another dimension. Just a fold.
Right.
A fold of the dimensional layers and skins.
I just think... So the reason that I bring up when we talk about space...
John's going to the bathroom.
All right, John. Good luck out there. When we bring up space, we talk about... the only reason that I occasionally mention it is because... It's always a foregone conclusion when we talk about extraterrestrials, other planets, like, oh, yeah, well, this, you know, ET reality, this whatever. I mention it because it's an idea that's out there, and I think it's fun. It's a fun thought experiment. And,
it is fun.
And it's a possible reality. In my mind, it is a possible reality that we don't understand. We've been lied to potentially about space. We don't really know how it works. And if things live out there, it may be different than what we understand. And and when it comes to the Earth, for instance, by the way, Pat's still in the conversation. I did, you know, we talked about this last night, and he's got some interesting points too. Pat, I'm not reading all your texts right now. What do you say? No heavenly bodies, just natural luminaries. Yes, obviously, Pat. Luminaries, that's the term that flat earthers will use for stars, lights in the sky.
Yeah, and I think where that becomes trouble too is like,
so problematic.
I didn't want to use that word, but I think there are interesting points that people in the flat earth community will make, and I think that there are interesting things to look at, and I think to totally discount some of those questions is really dumb. You should have these conversations, but I think some flat earthers, like, their point of evidence is this is in the Bible. I think that's where you get a little, you need to have better evidence.
Now you're mixing stuff. I mean,
that's what I'm saying is it's right. Mixed. I'm not saying that they all, because they don't.
That's like the Q stuff. It's like saying right. Like, because there, yeah, I mean, there is a big religious group within the Flat Earth community. There's also a lot of people that are just scientifically analyzing questions.
Oh, yeah, and I think those are the legitimate people who ask questions about a possible Flat Earth.
Simple things like shape of the Earth, right? Like how the size of the curve, if the Earth is curved, there's a formula for that. And if we can, if you know, we have a boat that goes so far over the, you know, over the horizon of the ocean, and it goes over the curve, it should be 400, 500.
At some point, you should be able to see it. 1,000 feet
beyond the curve below, and yet if you have a high-powered zoom lens or telescope, you can bring it back into view. There's no curve
like
at that
point. Like a telescopic
point.
Lens, like a high-powered.
Right,
yeah.
And that's a problem of just, it could just be a miscalculation of science.
Well,
of the
and
curve.
That's
well, you need to talk about that.
Yeah, that is my frustration with a lot of the Flat Earth stuff is the reaction that you get, and I get why people immediately will say, this is ridiculous, why would I even consider this? But it's weird how it's become, and I think if you're a listener of this show, I think you will agree that it's weird how it's become so triggering for people. If you mention the idea, the people will immediately get offended that you even ask the question, how is it possible that the Earth could be flat? Can you explain why this means it's spherical? Because I think, why would you not think it's...
I shouldn't have to tell you. You had a globe in kindergarten.
Well,
that's what I'm saying
is like everyone is told to believe, and I mean, I still think it's probably spherical. But again, I think there are definite questions to ask on that don't make sense with the spherical model or the oblong model or whatever it's called, the pear shape.
Until, I prefer to be agnostic when it comes to the shape of the Earth or any science that I can't prove myself.
Right.
I'd rather keep an open mind until I can prove to myself.
No, that's fair, but that's not usually the way you react to stuff.
Right. You that's the point is, I think, and what Pat is probably saying in the feed, you say you're Earth shape agnostic, but you definitely, you go pretty hard into the paint.
I know, with the flat earth stuff. You know, I like the underdog, so sometimes I will argue for it if no one else is.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't mean that I believe it 100%.
We kind of went into
Pat
the...
Pat said, yes, that space exists is a foregone conclusion. Natalie said, I think it is possible that everything we are taught about space is wrong. I can't get over how a spaceship shouldn't be able to move without something to push against. Okay, this is a really interesting point, actually. From what I understand, the way that it's tried to explain away, because it is a good point. In order to have propulsion, you have you're propelling the whatever the energy source is, whatever the propulsion is, it's pushing against, and that I don't know if friction is the right word, but the pressure against, like if I had gigantic lungs and I blew against that wall, I could roll my chair away by blowing against it, right? That propulsion against it. And you know, I'm not prepared for this, obviously, for like an episode on this idea, but I think what they say in space, because space is a vacuum and there is no real, you can't
gravitational.
There's no air pressure, so you can't blow, and then the pressure of the air pushing against your expulsion, you know, causing that propulsion. That can't happen in space. And what I think what they say,
at least by the way they say it,
right? What they would argue is that I think that in a rocket, in the chamber of the rocket, the explosion is somehow pushing off. There is some pressure inside the pushing off the pressure inside the rocket itself.
So the gravitational forces are working inside the rocket.
Well, it's not gravitational forces. It's just pressure. It's resistance.
Okay.
Essentially.
Yeah, but isn't the whole thing that space doesn't have any resistance?
Right. So I don't understand. That doesn't make
sense
to me. Does
that have to do with gravity, though?
No. It's just gravity is like being drawn towards, you know, a body with a certain amount of mass.
Yeah.
But this is just like, you know, if you.
So the fact there's no resistance in space has nothing to do with the fact there's no gravity.
Yeah, it's not really a gravity thing. That's more it's pressure, it's propulsion. Yeah, but yeah, to me that is an interesting point. Like, and I think that's a good question to ask, and we should have a scientist on the show to talk about if we ever do questions about space, like the idea of like how do we travel through space with propulsion if there's no air pressure to push against to create that propulsion. It's an interesting question.
We should.
Is the diacol lights?
What is that?
What?
Oh, I thought you'd get that.
What is that from?
Oh, Don Pettit.
Oh, Don Pettit, the astronaut.
Yeah.
Yeah. What did
he's not. Is he an astronaut? Yeah, he is an astronaut.
He's an astronaut, yeah.
Well, the guy we had on our...
The zodiacal light.
He was the guy on our moon landing episode, right? Mm-hmm. The clip.
Yes. They did do an interesting video with him and
this like very intelligent, like, what's the word? He knew a lot about physics and a lot about engineering.
Oh, Don Pettit?
No, the guy that went to interview Don Pettit.
Oh, yeah.
And they went in the little lunar, I don't know if it's lunar. It's
lunar module?
It's on the space station where it's like, it's this little thing that you sit in and there's like lights or there's windows
all
around.
The cockpit kind of
thing?
Maybe,
yeah.
I don't know what it's called.
But he was asking like these kind of very scientific questions about how like an O-ring works in this situation. Like he doesn't understand how it's possible. And so he was asking me and he's like, it's just really good engineering. And he's like, okay, that doesn't answer any of my questions.
Well, there are problems with the space station. If we ever do an episode on this or a live stream on this, it'd be fun. Jeremy's Crazy Corner.
I said this today. You said this today. For the Jeremy's
Crazy
Corner.
There are videos, and you could say that this is like, oh, some footage got mixed up or this was supposed to be training and they published it as live or whatever. But there, you know, you see shots of like, it's only a few astronauts on the space station and then they're shooting a shot of like a some doorway or something that's at, like an airlock or something into space. And then you see a guy just moving in with like a scuba tank on. And this is the thing is that they train underwater, right? For that, you know, anti-gravity kind of aesthetic, that feeling, mm-hmm. that buoyancy that gives them that feeling of anti-gravity. And, they're supposedly live, footage shots from space, from the space station where you catch glimpses of people. Well, first of all, you get air bubbles. Like that happens all the time on the space station. Then you get people, occasional shots of someone with like a looks like a diver with a scuba tank on just moving into a door frame. You know,
there's definitely seems to be a lot of weird video that's would seem like they're on a stage, right? That's kind of the,
this is why I wanted to do this because I recently saw from a guy I really like, YouTube channel Atlantean Gardens, Robert Seffer. He does a lot of history stuff. Is it Seffer? But he did one recently on the International Space Station. It was more of like just curious to see because I don't think he's on Jeremy's train completely with that stuff. So he played some really interesting clips of experiments on the International Space Station, and I'm gonna play one right now because I thought this was fascinating. And I want to because I've seen the videos you're talking about, Jer. And we should do a compare and contrast mm-hmm. eventually, but where, you know, it looks like there's wires or hairs acting weird, but this is one that I thought was, it doesn't look fake to me. It looks pretty real.
Let me, before you play
and
that.
And also I think to the argument that like to get the zero G effect, and if the space station isn't really in orbit, they're just filming in planes that are dropping that you can like pay tickets to do. And they're just doing that constantly.
Yeah.
I think that's a little unbelievable. To think that they're just constantly dropping and filming these things because they do them live.
Right.
And sometimes I think they're on for hours. So how can you have this, you know, fake zero G by planes dropping and then be on for hours at a time?
Mm-hmm.
Unless they've developed some lab to pretend there's zero. I don't know. It just seems, but I do have video queued and this is a washcloth in space.
Can
if
I,
you're interested,
let me just, before you do, since we're talking about flat earth and stuff, we did not mean to get into this tonight at all, but the 22G mentioned something. Didn't the flat earthers also disprove their own theory trying to prove flat earth? So I think he's referencing that documentary Beyond the Curve or Behind the Curve.
Oh, the Netflix one?
Yeah. Right. Which, so anyone who doesn't know, who hasn't looked into the flat earth stuff, they focused on this one kind of, I don't know, kind of not an egomaniac, but it was about him. Like he wore shirts to flat earth conventions that said, yes, I'm Mark Sargent.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Right? And so they focused on this guy. This one guy basically saying like, this is the flat earth movement. And
they always do that. They like pigeonhole.
Right. And there was one experiment they were trying to do that, one of the guys involved with it, he's actually, I forget. He's from Globebusters, I think is one of the channel or something, but
Globebusters. Yeah. Wow.
He has like the Ghostbusters logo, but it's the anyways. Yeah. You know, he's an intelligent guy. Like I've watched a lot of his videos, but, whether he's wrong or right. But, the way they did the Netflix documentary was really disingenuous. The way that they edited it, they never gave them the full footage like they promised to, and they edited the footage to make it look like they ended up failing, like they proved the Earth was round because their experiment failed. But the experiment just failed. They just weren't able, like there was a problem with the laser or something. And
were they doing the horizon sort of thing with the laser?
It was across the water. I forget exactly what the experiment was, but the experiment essentially didn't show anything about the shape of the Earth, but the way that they framed it made it look like, bam, bam, they just disproved the flat Earth.
I didn't
watch
it.
So just so you guys know, like there's more to that story, and I know that this is all crazy, and I don't even give a shit about the flat Earth. It's just my crazy corner piece.
It's surprisingly interesting, at least the question, at least as a a mental exercise, it's interesting to ask the question. And I think to demonize people who want to, because really think about it, if you're out there listening, what do you really know about the mechanics of space, the shape of the earth, and do you, can you, other than repeating what you've been told,
and if you, think
can you can you explain it? And I think that's interesting, because I don't think it's flat, but I think it's, I think people should have the right to ask the question, and it's not, without being ridiculed.
And it's not about it being flat. I think the whole point of it is just like, we don't it's necessarily the, believe right. that we've been told about the reality of the earth
the
itself.
The measurements
where we live.
Don't live up to what they say it is.
Right.
So what it could be oval. I don't know.
Right. Yeah. I mean, there's
what it is, right?
The concave like earth. There's all these ideas.
Yeah.
But the basic idea is like, just don't take for granted that what they show you in school is the truth. When you can't go out there and prove it yourself, if you believe everything you see in video form, then fine. It's, you know, a spinning sphere, and you know, there's a Tesla out there with an astronaut dummy.
I like
just
that idea.
Rotating
though.
Around.
And then one of the reasons, Jer, I think, you know,
I'm not trying to squash any like dreams or like,
yeah,
you know,
space is cool.
Space
Star
is cool.
Star Trek's cool. Aliens are cool. To say that
I know, I'm not
there's...
saying that it's not. I'm just saying it's cool to take. I think it's interesting, more interesting to challenge your previous held beliefs, because I wasn't born
right.
some an earth shape agnostic. I looked
you
into it
born,
and thought it was interesting.
You were born as a critical thinker, and that is your downfall.
Thanks, Chris.
That's why we have Jeremy's Crazy Corner.
That's what
we'll soon be doing.
I will challenge every obvious truth.
If you guys out there listening have any ideas for Jeremy's Crazy Corner, please submit them, as we will be making it a segment. Hopefully, you're interested after this conversation.
Worm Nights and Flat Earth.
I want to say let's go to the phones, but we don't have the phone set up. So let's go to the comments, Jer.
Oh, did you mention that we'll be doing phones?
Yeah.
Okay.
You were gone. We mentioned that. What do we got going on in the feed?
Oh.
I can't see. I think John can see because he's been eyes glued to the screen all night.
What can I see?
Are you watching the comment feed?
No.
What are you looking at?
It's none of your business.
Oh.
It's credit score.
I thought with a video stream you wouldn't be doing this.
I was looking at the comment. I mean.
There we go.
I'm looking at other articles related to this.
Hey, our good friend Aaron Franciscioni says, have you ever met someone who thinks the moon is hollow? Aaron,
oh, man,
if the
yeah.
moon is a three-dimensional planetoid,
it's most likely hollow.
It is definitely hollow. I actually have a book called
Who Built the Moon?
Who Built
we'll
the
be
moon.
Doing that this upcoming season, probably one of the first episodes. Yeah. I really want to do that episode. It is fascinating. The anomalies that are involved with the moon are mind-blowing. The location,
Isaac Asimov, what did he say about the moon? He said something like,
it shouldn't exist, basically.
Basically, it should not exist in a rational world. It is, the moon is 400 times...
you're actually going to try to list the facts.
Oh,
okay.
just off memory. It's 400 times smaller than the sun. Or wait, that can't. It's got to be much smaller than that, I think. Basically, the where it's set in our orbit. See, I'm talking like a you know, round earther. Where it's set in our orbit
around Earth
is that it's 400 times closer to us than the sun, and it's also 400 times smaller. Is that
yeah.
how it works? However that proportion works, it's perfectly positioned in orbit around the Earth to block out the sun perfectly for a solar eclipse. I don't know if we know of anywhere that
also,
exists besides here.
Life exists on this planet because of the moon, because of its station. We haven't found anything.
Well, it's in a tidal lock. Right?
Right.
Meaning like it travels around the Earth. It's always front facing the Earth. It's not rotating.
Here's the back clip from the book. I'll read this real quick. This is Who Built the Moon. The authors of Civilization One Return, bringing new evidence about the moon that will shake up our world. Christopher Knight and Alan Butler realized that the ancient system of geometry they presented in their earlier breakthrough study works as perfectly for the moon as it does the Earth. On further investigation, they found a consistent sequence of beautiful integer numbers. When looking at every major aspect of the moon, no such pattern emerges for any other planet or moon in the solar system. In addition, Knight and Butler discovered that the moon possesses few or no heavy metals and has no core. Pretty interesting. Something that should be not possible. Their persuasive conclusion, quote, if higher life only developed on Earth because the moon is exactly what it is and where it is, it becomes unreasonable to cling to the idea that the moon is a natural object. The only question that remains is, who built it? And that's fascinating. And if you remember, we talked about this, I think maybe on our moon landing episode, but the idea that the moon rang like a bell.
Yeah.
That it's hollow. When
it struck, it rang for, I don't know how many minutes it was that it continued to vibrate and ring like a giant.
Yeah, they have
bell.
Seismograph recordings. Yeah,
they repeated the experiment too. And mm-hmm. again, the same ringing, I think longer the second for whatever reason. But we'll definitely do an episode on that because I think it's one of the coolest ideas out there. The idea that, and you go back to, there's cultures in the world, and we'll have to dig deeper in this, that talk about the moon being pulled into our orbit. Like wasn't there at some point, and then it was pulled in.
There's some, I think, old Vedic texts.
That's probably what it was.
The ancient texts where they talk about in the before time, essentially. That's not what they called it, but that the moon, they talked about the time when the moon was dragged in to our orbit.
Yeah.
Which, it's so perfectly positioned. It just seems like, I think the odds are like so many trillion to one that we would have a moon that is perfectly positioned to create that eclipse. It's just so insane. So we should definitely do a deeper dive on that. I think it'd be interesting to do. Any last video clips or thoughts or anything?
Did you find anything interesting?
I was reading the comments.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Any good comments over there?
I'm just trying to think one that stands out.
Someone says, Chris, you're the most beautiful man I've ever seen.
Didn't NASA
Thank you,
crash,
Sarah 212.
Didn't NASA crash a satellite into the moon and it started reverberating like a bell?
Yeah, that's what I was referring to. That was probably written before I said that. Yeah. Was it a satellite? Yeah, I think it was. Yeah, we'll definitely do an episode on this.
Also, I think when the lander landed. Or no, when they...
Oh, Pat says... where did you say that?
It's hollow, of course.
Pat said...
Oh, it's hollow, of course, because it's actually a dragon egg.
Pat.
Space
He's
dragons.
Had one too many gin and tonics.
I had a great conversation with him last night. We talked about conspiracy theory. We talked about...
It's good man.
Relationships, yeah. To you, Pat. Good old friend. Decades.
Any other, Jeremy, I wish you could put them up there so I could see the comments.
I can put it up there.
Any other final comments, guys?
Yeah, we're going to have to wrap it up here.
Thanks for staying with us. Hit the like button if you got
Smash that like button. Will that work on the unlisted videos?
It doesn't really matter on a listed.
Yeah, I don't know, but just get in the habit.
You can subscribe.
Oh, yeah, I was going to mention this, guys. This is...
Wait, who fell asleep? Somebody said they fell asleep.
What? Go back to that comment. Find them. Find them.
Kids are asleep.
Oh,
kids are. Okay. That's Patrick.
Yeah,
kids asleep.
Patrick came
back. Yes.
She's a good mommy. So, what I was going to mention was, these were kind of two experiments for you guys, and for us, to do a live stream for members only, patrons only.
Right.
Two things I wanted to say. One, if you guys are down for it, we are going to be moving away from Patreon. We're still going to have Patreon. It's still going to be active.
Well, they don't have a choice in it.
What do you mean?
Well, you said if you're down for it.
Well, I'm saying like they don't have to train.
They can
stay.
I get what you're saying.
Yeah, but we're creating another platform, and it's going to basically be more under our control. It's going to be customized for us. Patreon doesn't eat 30% of everything you guys donate to us, so it'll help the show more. If you move over there, that's going to be something coming up that we'll announce to you guys when that's ready.
You won't be a Patreon member, but you will be a Belieflings expansion member, which is way cooler than just
a
generic
it's
Patreon
just
member.
It's more legitimate than Patreon for sure.
And it's safer because, you know, we won't get censored, shut down, you know, removed or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Not that we're in big threat of that, but a lot of people have been, and I don't like that.
And they won't take a 30% cut or whatever it is.
Yeah. Other thing I was going to mention was these two live streams we've done with you guys, these have been kind of experiments for us, and special because we get to share them with you guys, and it's kind of like closer connection. I don't know if it's going to be the next stream or the stream after. We're going to start doing live for anyone on YouTube. So that'll be interesting to see. It'll open us up to different kind of, I don't know, experience. It won't be as like, we won't be able to keep up with everybody.
Depending on how many, we'll see. It'll be definitely because there's a lot of people that listen to us that aren't patrons, so they'll be able to check.
We'll
it
still
out
have. We're trying to figure out how to do this. We're probably still going to have a live stream, or at least maybe continue the stream for patrons only. That's when we'll probably do the calls and stuff where you can interact with us more. So we'll still have an expansion member stream option, maybe a different tier. We're not sure yet, but. Something exclusive to you guys. So we won't just be doing, maybe at first, just be doing
YouTube live streams?
We don't know.
We don't know.
The point is, Chris is
just saying things.
I'm just talking a lot.
The point is, we just appreciate you guys being
here. Talking a lot.
It means a lot, and you guys have. I don't know. It's really helped us to just experiment with stuff, and like you know us so well. We've been doing this for so long. You guys have been supporting us for so long that as we grow, it's just cool to be able to talk to you guys and get your opinions. And,
yeah, it's fun to get the feedback in real time because, you know, so much of it is done in our own time.
Yeah.
But to see people, you know, talking to each other and talking back, it's definitely, it's invigorating.
Yeah. And edifying. Edifying. Rejuvenating.
Absolutely. Okay. I'm checking the comments one last time.
They never put them up on the screen.
I mean, I'm doing it now. Popping it. I had to figure out how to pop it out.
Pop it out.
Man, there's something I want to play in a cool aerobics video. There's some things I want to get to tonight.
Where's Jake? Tammy says.
He's coming. We're going to get a Jake cam going.
Yeah. Where, how are we going to keep him quiet, though?
Huh?
How are we going to keep him quiet?
He's pretty quiet.
He doesn't make noise.
He hears people outside driving around.
I mean, he might bark once in a blue moon. That's pretty rare. But that's true. It's not going to affect the quality of the show.
All right, what else we got?
This is the moment where we all stare in the same direction.
Yeah, I love the comments that I don't know what's going on because it's conversation within the chat. Yeah.
Jeff Nord, what's up, man? I didn't see you.
Yeah, thanks for making it, Jeff. I know last time you missed it because your son was building that sweet-ass video game machine. I don't know what to call it. Video game computer? I sound so old.
Oh, he's been growing his beard for 10
gaming,
years.
Gaming computer. It looked awesome. So thanks for being here, man. That's awesome.
All right. Yeah. I guess any questions before
thanks,
we go?
Brian.
Thanks, Brian King.
What'd Brian say?
Take my money.
Gump said, take my money. Give it up, Gump.
Zach. What did Brian say? I missed that comment. Oh, good job, Jen. Well, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
I wish. See, this is where it'd be good to be able to put the chats on screen.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, we can. Can't we put
Isn't
them on?
Isn't that what you're doing right now?
Well, for us. I mean, it'd be cool to put it in the video.
Oh, right, yeah.
But people will see the playback, I guess, on live streams. But
take my money, Pedro says. Well, you don't have to ask twice.
Take your well we are every month. Thank you guys.
Believe
well,
it until the Jeff, end. Well, thank you guys.
What was the song that I made for Jeff? Oh no, it was that?
Well, that was so good. It was like
it was the 80s like sci-fi
documentary. Yeah, Boards of Canada style.
That's right.
That was
great. Fun.
Here we have the Nordlinger.
The Nordlinger.
That's so good.
All right. Well.
All right.
Anything else before we depart? Closing thoughts.
Love
the
you guys.
The hole is expanding. Thank you, Josh. Thank you, everybody, for, by the way, sharing the show with other people. We constantly get messages from people saying their friends showed us the show. So it's because of you
Keep
guys.
Keep spreading it.
Keep spreading the hole.
Wide
Keep
open.
Spreading that hole.
Oh, God.
Span the hole.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Stretch it open and invite your friends inside.
that's really, really bad.
That's bad.
The further you go with it, the worse it
anybody
gets.
Who lives nearby will be going to the bar next door to watch.
We should get a
Craig Neal and his ghost band.
We should get a quick look at, like, everyone write down your state that you're
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Tell us where you guys are. This would be a good, like, how do you do?
Because we would love to do, like, an in-person meeting at some point.
A city,
like,
if you want to include the city, let's see the city, too. It'd be no pressure.
If you could just paste your personal address, we will come door to door to say hello.
That's a weird statement.
We won't be doing that. Absolutely the case. Don't do that, for real.
Work on the Jake cam, guys. We will, Aaron. Don't you worry. Everybody loves Jake, John.
Aaron, good guy.
Corey, about the bright lights, I haven't really worked on too much new music, but
Belieflings has swallowed all of our.
Yeah, it's
hobbies.
kind of the. I mean, I have I have my other job, which is still audio related, so I haven't had a ton of time.
I have nothing else.
I have been working on creepy kids poetry for a while, and then as soon as we started doing the show, just everything shut down. Photography gone.
Yeah, we'll get you, Jake, coming up soon.
All right, well.
There's a lot of Jake.
There's a lot of Jake going on.
There's a delay. It's like
all right.
2 second delay.
Tell us your states.
Tell us your
Where
states.
Where do you live? All right.
Everyone wants to give us money. Well, at least a couple people.
Oh, yeah. We don't have there's no super chat.
Yeah.
Money donation.
That's only on if it's unlisted. This is a private just for our patrons.
If you want to send us money, go to,
to belieflings.com.
Yeah, there's a PayPal button. I
gaming
would use
PC.
That.
Well, is this delayed? Gaming PC.
What?
Pat corrected me. It's a gaming PC.
How long ago was that?
That was a little while ago.
You know, we did have a low bit rate.
Yeah, this is
you know
very
what? We
delayed.
Might be like a minute delayed.
If I look, actually, guys, if you can
two
see,
minutes delayed.
You guys can see my
I can't
computer.
See
the, I was just trying to show you.
Oh, that's not very delayed. I think people are just ignoring us.
Beards
are totally
hot.
Come on. That was a long ago comment.
No, but they've been going back and forth with that one for a while.
There was, I was going to bring up a note about that. I can't now.
Well, thanks, Jeff. Great to have you here, man.
Man, this is a really long delay.
That they are. I think people were saying we're gorgeous. I'm just guessing that. I haven't seen the feed, but I'm guessing
the beards are gorgeous.
Oh.
They like the beards.
Yeah. I don't know if they mean our beards. It might just mean beards in general.
I shaved mine too short last time because I had the thing where
you... think it means ours.
Do you ever have we
take a percentage of my income? Yes, there is actually.
We're not the government, Zay. We're not going to do that.
We're going to tax you. Belief hole tax.
No. That would be great.
Missed the whole thing. Michael, you son of a bitch.
Michael.
Michael, it will be.
How dare you,
wait,
Michael.
Be is that Michael or Michelle?
Michelle, sorry. My bad.
Yeah, come on,
Michelle. I'm reading it from a distance.
From a distance.
I'm not seeing any locations.
Thank you, Jacob Steele.
That's true. Are we that far behind? Or maybe people just aren't interested in sharing their location. That makes sense.
Spread the hole. Where is the... Tell us where you live.
Shaking the whole table. Angry John, the gentle giant. Gentle no more. Camp out in the hole. That sounds fun.
Okay. Well...
Well, people really don't
want
to get
the location. It's funny how we're just waiting for the...
Oh, one thing I want to say because...
Florida. Nevada. There it comes.
Okay. It was way delayed. California. Yeah, Vermont, Michigan, PA. Oh, this is great. We're going to we got a Canuck. That's awesome.
We're going to be reading Michigan. These later.
Yeah, we must be like 5 minutes behind.
So about 5 minutes, they're going to be hearing us start reading states.
Yeah, sorry guys, this is boring that we've been reading comments you wrote 10 minutes ago. Apparently, it's pretty delayed.
Denver, Colorado, and my address
we probably shouldn't read this now.
Oh, Induce Fear Podcast. All right.
Oh, nice.
Good guys.
We'll check these comments out later. I feel like it's weird now because we're so far delayed. But I want to let you guys know we will be doing the call-in thing eventually for probably exclusively, I would think, expansion members.
Yeah, for patrons, yeah.
We're going to do one more live stream for patrons.
But you think we'll do that before we come back?
Yeah, we need to do... We said we'd do one every week.
Yeah, but we're closing in on getting ready for...
We've only done two.
They might want an expansion episode, you know?
Huh? Well, we'll have that first of the... Or the beginning of the next month.
Well, we'll have to look at it.
It's only the 16th right now. It's going to be another couple weeks before we get an episode out.
Yeah. we got to research and record.
I know, but we're going to launch the new platform. I think we'll have time though.
We have even if videos just, that we didn't play. This yeah, is easy to do.
It's a hangout in the
hangout.
Hole. All right. You know, I think it's just nice to connect with people while we're working on stuff in the background.
And we owe them because, well, you know, we don't owe you shit.
Yeah, we do. We do.
All right, guys. I think we're...
Yeah, we love you. Sorry, the comments.
Sick
sorry.
Outro music. I don't know. Let me see if I can find
let's
something
pull some
quick.
Up. Let's do some. That's a good idea. Who wrote that? That's a great idea. We should always have outro music. What do you play, John?
I don't know.
Do you want some Epidemic?
Yeah, but I could have to preview the music, and that might be...
No, just play one. Play one in a playlist we have. I have an outro music playlist.
Oh, you do?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right, we'll just...
Ooh,
see.
Ooh, play Sunset. Overdrive, I think is what it's
Sunset
called.
Drive?
That's perfect outgoing music.
Is that the one that's bound?
Yeah. Bound. Will you hear it? Or should I play it? This is very important. This is a very important part of the show. So sorry we're talking about it, but we need to play some sexy outro
Night
music.
Stalker?
That's a good one.
That's a good one.
It's a little darker, but it's good.
Sunset Drive.
There
Sunset
you go. Drive. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed tonight's episode.
Love you
episode.
Guys. Thank you. You really do make it like awesome for us. Without you, we'd just be talking to ourselves all the time.
Right, which we do anyway.
Yeah.
But it would be
it's not nearly
much
fun.
Less enjoyable and yeah. satisfying.
If you guys have any thoughts about the live streams, what you'd like to see, what you'd like to hear, how much interactivity you'd like, let us know. Send us
what
an email.
What are your thoughts? What are your
ideas?
Yeah,
and if you had a comment you really wanted us to respond to, feel free to email us. brothers@believehole.com or check out the website and leave a message there. Click on contact.
Oh, there it is. Crank that shit.
We love you. We love you deeply. And deeply do.
We do love you. And we love that you love us.
We love it.
There's
John
a lot
loves
of love.
That you love us.
There's a lot of love.
John, will you dance us out?
Yeah, can you boost that volume a bit?
Yeah, boost the volume.
It's kind of quiet.
Here it comes.
Jeremy, can you cut the John?
Yeah.
Good night, everybody. We love
night,
you.
Night, everybody. We'll leave you with John.
We'll leave you with John.
There he is.
That is the... See that face, John?
It's the most, so like, effeminate.
It's so ridiculous.
It's your face.
That.
That was, you practiced a better dance earlier. Look how serious you get with it. He's so like trying to. Yeah, there it is. That's the worst dance.
So cheesy. So bad. So cheesy.
Oh, it's so good.
All right, guys. All right, we love you.
Oh, man. Oh, God.
Good night.
Love you. Have a good night, yeah, everybody. We'll see you soon.
Peace
next
out.
Week.
Sweet dreams. Sweet dreams. I'm gonna fade this out. I need like an out clip. I need an out clip. All right. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Fade to black.
I don't have that option.